I don't know what's going on, but I tell you, okay, why is that? Let me see, man. Something ain't right. Okay, y'all can hear me, but what in the hell is going on? My sound effects ain't working for some reason on some of them, and I ain't understanding it. Saved my life. The stuff acting weird, Paulo. What's up, E-Dub? What channel is this on? Showtime. On Showtime. But yeah, man, no, have my sound effects acting stupid. Like, some of it's working. My pop-ups pop up, but they ain't got no sound to them. Or at least I can't hear them on this end, and I ain't understanding that. Or whatnot. What are they doing? Oh man, they showing what? This is a replay. Oh, they showing her. I think they for the show a replay. Hold on, I don't even hear the sound for this.
It's time.
I heard the sound from that, but I don't know if I can fix this while I'm live. But I ain't finna. Yeah, they showing a replay of the Javonte Davis fight. So if anybody missed that Javonte Barrios fight is coming on. I didn't know they was going to do a replay first. I've been meaning to watch this fight again anyways. But, yeah, man, I don't know what they... this whole stuff, with stuff like this happened to throw me off because I was playing with them before I went live. And then as soon as I went live, I don't know what the world is. Like, my Kobe don't work. It show that it's saying something. But it ain't saying nothing.
Kobe!
Like, you know what I'm saying? You know. But it ain't saying nothing. I don't know what that's about. At all. Yeah, Polo, man. I don't know what the heck going on. You know, you jump here you want to, Polo. Just let me know. I'll put the link in the chat. I'll do it like that. Watch, either way, I send you a link. It don't matter. No problem, E-Dub. You know what it is. I'm sorry. I'm probably talking about boxing. I'm up here bugging out because it's like every once, it's like an update coming in and mess up stuff sometimes. I probably just got to erase the sounds and reprogram them, but I don't feel like doing all that, though. That's too much light work, bro. Like, I'm about to see if this other stuff works. Can y'all hear this box of bill? Let me see. I just got to erase the sounds and reprogram them, but I don't feel like doing all that, though. That's too much light work, bro. Like, I'm about to see if this other stuff works. Can y'all hear this box of bill? Yeah, y'all can hear that box of bill, but why my other shit not working, bro? Let me do something. It's going to look weird, but hold on. Boom. Now let's see if they work over here. Nope. They don't even work on this side. Back to the boxer side. So, nope. It don't even work. It's something. I'm going to have to reprogram this shit. Because, oh, you know what? Hold on. It could be. Let me find one. What about Kobe? Where Kobe at? There go Toasty.
Toasty!
Nope, that ain't it. See, I thought it was something else. It ain't that. It's something with this. I think it just needs to be restarted. I ain't finna do all that. Then I had to go to Relive and Vance Properties. All right, how about this?
Kobe!
Kobe, where you at? You popped up. Monitoring output. I don't hear it. Let's see if we hear it again.
Kobe!
Nope.
Kobe! Kobe!
There you go. What the hell?
Kobe! Kobe!
I don't know. I guess I gotta go through each one and play with it. I don't know. So this is supposed to be monitor off.
Toasty. Nothing,
right? Now I go back to monitor output.
Toasty.
Yeah, I gotta play with them. They working now, yeah. It's double because I got this on. Now. Now they shouldn't be double.
Toasty.
But I need to replace them anyways.
Toasty.
It's all good. That's all it's telling me because I need to put them on my soundboard. That's all it's telling me. Quit being lazy. But my pop-ups, I got to figure out how to put my pop-ups on my soundboard. You know what I'm saying? Like my slap. Like you can't hear that right now. Monitor off. Monitor off. But let's see if it works now. Yeah, I gotta be able to see if I put my pop-ups on my soundboard. I don't know. So we should see. There we go. So now my slap should work. Now I know I get Jordan back. This little nigga that snuck up in here.
I
knew you weren't gonna want it. Okay. You cool? Alright. Don't watch TV. I eat it. That get off the green screen. You messing it up, big head. Love you. And you're off screen. Yeah. I was off screen. I was in this section where it ain't no camera. But now I know what it is. I can stop panicking and I can take my butt back off screen. Y'all gonna see the background because I'm about to sneak eat a little bit. I don't like eating in front of people, bro. But I learned that today. Hey, that cool. Slide in, slide out. I've been messing with this thing all day. It's got like this new update on OBS where you can do a whole lot more stuff. You know what I'm saying? Today's been the worst allergy today ever. I'm talking about eyes was watering, had to pull out the shade, prescription shades. The sun was even agitating my eyes. It was crazy. But I guess I'm finna sit here and watch Floyd look like Mr. T again with all them chains on. And Javante take this fight over. I so thought they were gonna show the undercards to the other fight. They're gonna show this and go straight to the B-Hop fight. I am. But that's whack. But if you don't want to watch this and you want to come back, I totally understand. But I will tell you this. I did upload a video about Anthony Joshua versus Usyk. Alexander Usyk. Man, I'm telling you, check it out. It's fire. I got thinking about that fight. I'm like, dude, that's going to be a good-ass fight, bruh. Like, people sleeping on that fight, bruh. I think that's going to be a better fight than Fury and Deontay. Just because Usyk could box. You know what I'm saying? Usyk could box. And he more naturally a cruiserweight. Like Deontay. Both of the fights are kind of similar. Damn, I thought I took my ass off screen. I was playing with it. That's what it was. There we go. Yeah. Both of the fights are similar, though. It's like Dave versus Goliath on both ends. both of these cats weigh about 250 or more. And then against the little guy, Deontay, the small guy, then you got Alexander Usyk. So Alexander can fight. Good feet movement. He's a busy body. I'm telling you, stay busy. I think it's going to be dope. Okay, here we go, Polo. Hold on 1 second. I'm about to set him up. Let me go and set this up. Boom, boom, boom. Boom, boom, boom. Where we at? Of course I look amazing, nigga. Motherfucker stupid. Don't need no cam. What is it doing? Bruh, I'm trying to stop cam. Stop cam. All right, we know that. We know this. Just let me stop the cam. There we go. Edit avatar, nigga. That ain't the right. All right. Boom. Invite. Boom. Gmail. Gmail. Hey, you know what? We gonna open this platform up. Delete that. Copy the clipboard. How about that? Live stream. Paste. I'm finna send it to your Gmail too, because I don't know if you're trying to get on your laptop, so I'm finna send it to you on a laptop as well. Oh, he already came up in here, bet. Let me send it to myself in case. Oh, my dude busy. That's right, he busy, so he ain't gonna be able to get on. Yeah. Oh. Oh. Polo.
What's good?
What's happening, boy?
Shit. Tired.
Nigga said tired.
Tired as heck, man. What's going on with this fight?
Man, shit, goddamn me. Shit, you know, I'm just a fan of B-Hop. He just don't get the right opposition. You know, he was supposed to be, once upon a time, he was Devin Haney mandatory.
Man, how things have changed.
Yeah, then shit got moved around and shuffled around. When Teofimo became champ, it was, Ryan was Devin mandatory and B-Hop. Then that shit got switched rule around somehow. Because everybody's like, how the fuck did Devin Haney end up with two mandatories? That's some bullshit. And Teofimo didn't have one because he ended up getting that franchise built.
It could have worked in Devin's favor. All he had to do was just manage the fights correctly.
Well, he was supposed to fight Ryan first. And remember, Ryan won that fight, and Ryan said he wasn't going to fight Devin. He didn't want to fight Devin, so that's, yeah. Pretty much so, that's how it was supposed to go. Yep. Let me get on.
He could have fought B-Hop instead of Linares.
Say what now?
He could have fought B-Hop instead of Linares.
Facts.
He could have, but just didn't go that way.
Yeah, that's because, you know, names, money. You know, B-Hop ain't got a name like that, but B-Hop just need that one time to shine, you know?
Yeah. That's true. It's just, it's crazy because things are starting to come out and start to notice different things. Certain fights could happen. It's just whether or not the fighter wants them to happen.
Facts. No lie.
And I'm starting to think that it would have been much more beneficial for Devin Haney to fight B-Hop than it was to fight Linares. Because you see the outcome, how he was basically crucified in the media.
Right.
So, it might have been better off to fight him. Yeah. But Showtime just threw this fight out of nowhere.
Yeah, I remember it was supposed to come on, but then it wasn't promoted. like that. And Nyambayar, he's a fighter, so it's going to be a fight. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes B-Hop could choose to be reserved. Nyambayar going to make it a fight.
So, hopefully.
Yeah, hopefully.
About to grab Showtime to see what it's about.
I just tripped off y'all seeing what I'm doing live on this joint. Boom, there we go. Shots is 7 up in this joint. Well, it was 7 shrunk down that quick as soon as I clipped over. But anyway, y'all watching and watching. It dropped like straight to 2 now. But probably because they see me working on the screen as well. Like I got 2 screens going. Oh, snap. Why is it showing that now? Oh, duh. My bad. It's going to show whatever's on that screen. All right, got it. Huh?
Yo, something weird is going on with my page.
Man, YouTube been doing some weird shit. Do you know that live I did? Didn't get on to today. Like, today or something, I couldn't find that mother nowhere like how they did yours that time.
Yeah.
I couldn't find that mother nowhere. And then when I would find, when I found it, wouldn't let me play it.
I got my notifications on my phone. And it said that I had a whole line of new subscribers. It said, congratulations, new subscriber, new subscriber, new subscriber. It was at least 10 of them, right? I went to my channel, wasn't none of that on there.
Oh no, YouTube been tripping, man.
I don't know if they're doing a update or something, but they should at least let somebody know what the heck is going on.
Right. No, that's a fact. That's a fact. And like my chat don't be working. What is this popping up here? What? I don't know what that's about doing right now. This is what I'm talking about. YouTube tripping, bro. YouTube tripping, bro. Now I got 2 up here, and I don't know what this is about. Somebody else just tried to come in. Somebody, who is that trying to come in? Hold on, I got to look at the chat, man. I don't know who that was. They just left out, though. But yeah, man. YP Money Music. It say device not connected, fam. Say device not connected, and you gotta figure out how to get your camera connected. It ain't gonna let me let you in.
I guess I can go ahead and show my face for all intents and purposes and be fair. Ain't no point in me being in and not showing my face.
Yeah, I'm on here. Well, don't lie, you can see me. Cause I'm going,
no,
I'm going,
you're not even on camera on live.
No, I'm saying I can though, see.
Oh.
I just can't be on. I didn't start it up right. Like, if I would have started with one camera on there first and then came to OBS, I would be on 2 cameras. You know what I'm saying? But I got to do it like this guy went through OBS first. It's like a certain order you got to do. I just don't like eating on camera. Huh?
That sound like work.
No, it ain't. It's just me being stupid. Like, not realizing. And then, like, live video on your YouTube. I don't know why not, but it's acting dumb. I know this thing acting dumb. Talking about what it can't find. And then it keeps switching.
Man. I don't know, man. There's something about this week that was just so draining for us fight weeks. This,
it was just a lot.
I don't know. It's just, man. There's news out there, but then there's a lot of rumors going on, too.
Oh, yeah.
Like, there's a lot of rumors. Wednesday put a lot of rumors to rest. Or the judges' table put a lot of rumors to rest.
Yeah, for sure.
But people are still, and then the news that we're breaking, a lot of people are just now breaking it. And all that different type of jazz.
It's almost like we need to slow down shit. Cause they can't catch up.
God,
they can't
almost
catch up.
Like that.
Yeah, right. We've been breaking news left and right. That we have been doing.
Ooh,
this is making me mad, bro. Like, what in the world is really going on? I'm trying to do a pop-out chat. YouTube is being the dumbest thing available right now, bro. The chat may not be visible. What? Look, bro. Quit playing with me. I'm finna close you. I'm tired of hearing the fireworks, though. That shit is nerve-wracking.
I don't enjoy the fireworks on 4th of July anymore.
Hey, it's stupid now. Let me do a pop-out chat. There we go. That's all I want. Put you down at the bottom. I can bring you over here somewhere. There we go. Ryan Garcia got one also, but I wouldn't buy that shit. Sook, you buy the Tyson. And Chuck, they not out yet. I got mine for pre-order, though. They got Mike Tyson. It's Mike Tyson, Chavez, and... Oh, yeah, that's what you talking about, Ryan Garcia. I'm going to buy it just because it's boxing. I'm going to get Ryan Garcia's. Because, see, the thing is, if they sell, they'll go after other licenses. They already had a Chavez license. His stuff was only sold in Mexico. They been had a Pacquiao license. It's only sold in Asia. So if you want them, all you got to do is go to eBay, or you can even go on Funko and type it in. You can get them. They just not sold in America. So they see boxing heating up. You know what I'm saying?
Man. All they need now is just a Floyd one.
Huh? A Floyd one? Yeah. Floyd gonna want that bag, though. See, Floyd gonna want a piece of that company or some shit. There ain't gonna never be no Floyd. Never.
That guy's so damn greedy.
Yeah, just like ain't gonna be in no game and ain't gonna be none of that. He ain't gonna never be on no game or nothing. You gonna have to create a player.
Yeah, I'm coming to grips with the esports thing that the next fighter's being announced. Floyd won't be in one.
Uh-uh.
Won't be one of them.
Fuck no. If they got Chris. Yeah, Chavez is on there. Where my phone? Hold on, I'm going to show you. I got so excited, I took pictures. I was like, "Up, oh, Toys of Our Youth. Did you see this? I need you to get these for me."
That's the boy got toy sponsorships. He's a real.
He's really? A real
Toys R Us right now. Mic?
Oh, wait, my camera not up. Let me stop eating and pull my camera up. Dumbass. There we go. Oh, that's my baby. My bad. That's not Mike. This one dope. This is a must have. Mike Tyson. Can y'all see that? Does Mike Tyson go hard? He even got the part in his hair. That's what I like about it. All black, red glove. Then you got the Chavez with the band and everything. That's so hard. He got the green shoes on, you know. Green and red, but you can't see him because of the green screen. That's tough. Then you got the Ryan Garcia, which looked like more like a De La Hoya. That should have been a De La Hoya to me. You know what I'm saying? Because he looked older. It don't look like a young cat.
I thought it was De La Hoya.
Right. People going to customize it. Watch. Look at this because it's hair and everything. You know what I'm saying? They going to customize it and make it a De La Hoya. Watch. And yes, just like their sneaker customizers, they're all Funko customizers.
I did not know that.
Yeah, look up Funko Boss. She cold as hell. She cold as hell, boy. She done made everything, and they done stole shit from her.
Grimy game.
It is.
Grimy game.
It is, man.
Oh, these large corporations get away with stuff like that.
Yep, but he does. Hey, I'm on them. I got both of my Ali's, of course, the black and white and the color one. I want the two-pack. It was so cool about the Manny Pacquiao one, which I'm finna get because if you retire, they're going to go all the way up, is the it's a two-pack, whereas He got the belt, I think, around his waist. I could be wrong. He just ended up with yellow shorts and red gloves. And then the other ones, when you know he owned a basketball team. He played basketball in the Philippines. This man had done it all. And they got him in his basketball uniform. I want to get that two-pack.
Really?
Yep. I'm going to show y'all. Man, I'll be on all that shit. Watch it. Manny Pacquiao, Funko Pop, two-pack.
They got the, you talking about the double pack on eBay for $200.
Yeah, it could be going. Okay, here we go.
Coach, he coached and played.
Yep, he owned the team. Here you go. Here go the single one. This the single pack. This the one where, and notice at the top it say Asia. I don't know if it'll focus enough. There you go. See, I say Pop Asia. It's only sold in Asia. And then you got the two-pack. Oh, no.
It's cheaper on eBay than it is on StockX.
That's because some niggas be getting desperate, bro. They want that money. Hurry up and just cash out. Here you go. And see, it was a convention exclusive in Asia. So it wasn't even in their stores. You had to go to see it. You had a basketball uniform on. Yellow shorts, red gloves. I want to get all three. Box the coach and player. That man done it all.
He do need to sit down somewhere.
Yes, he do.
Philippines' most interesting man right now.
Right, for real.
He probably done tamed cobras.
I promise you.
I wouldn't be surprised if you see a video with him with a cobra sitting on his lap.
Petting it like a dog.
Yeah. And the cobra just looking at the reporter like, I wish you would move.
Right. Like, it's okay for him. It's okay for him. It ain't okay for you. You lost your mind.
And have a Komodo dragon there on a leash.
Right.
I would not be surprised, because that's goddamn Manny Pacquiao. What can't he do?
Man, could you imagine the commercials he would have had with Nike?
Yeah.
All because he
doing
said
doing water aerobics with great white sharks.
Yeah, all because of the gay, anti-gay comments he made. They would have had crazy commercials for him.
But he don't care.
Nah, he got too much money.
He got too much money to care about what Nike think. I was about to say something. I'm glad June is over. I'm glad June is over.
Well, I'm trying to eat my food, nigga. Yeah, all right.
You caught on. I'm glad June is over.
Oh, yeah, I caught on, nigga. That's hilarious.
I can watch TV again.
That nigga, so I'm glad this show, goddamn it. Shout out to the five people were here, man. I thought the dang on fight was going to start, but they got the other fight on, so we enjoying that.
Oh, man.
You missed the Davis fight and Barrios. Javante Tank Davis fight. It's on Showtime right now in round 4. And as we joking, I'm watching him. This man took a lot more shots than I remember. Davis, that is.
Yes, he did. He did.
Barrio just respected him too much.
If Barrios came in there with a killer, with the killer's intent, he could have stopped Davis.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. But he showed he had the power to knock him out. He showed
he rattled him a few times.
Oh, yeah, he did. It's just Tank that. Wanted it more. He was willing to take those hits to get the inside.
And that's when Barrio should have been fighting off his back foot.
But I'm like you, though. Floyd should not have been able to come in, up to that ring and talk. Gonna tell that boy he was losing.
See, I believe there's a certain place for the promoter. and then there's a certain place for the corner.
But that amped him up more, though. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It made him go in there. If his trainer didn't tell him that, he shouldn't have been.
There should nobody else
be nobody else be able to tell him.
Mm-hmm. Because he was going to be completely honest, he was going to lose the fight on points.
Yeah, that was Floyd told him on the unofficial scorecard, you losing. He was like, on the unofficial, he was like, yeah, the unofficial. He was like, and he looked at him and got mad. He said, you won't get mad at me? I'm going to keep it 100 with you. You losing on the unofficial scorecard. That's when he came out, started rushing. But see, that's a bit of influence in the fight. You get what I'm saying, though? Like, mm-hmm. I don't think you should be able to do that.
No, he shouldn't have. But it's the past. What's done is done. Can't take it away.
Yeah, well, it ain't certain cheating because
certain fighters have certain privileges.
Yeah, but I don't think I don't constitute it as like cheating because his trainers could find out too, though. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. True, but should nobody that's not standing on that ringside be able
should,
to talk?
Should say nothing. Right. Should nobody say nothing unless it was a trainer. That's what I'm saying.
Mm-hmm. Like the same way, whenever there's a knockdown, your quartermen are not supposed to come up there on that ring.
Right.
The same thing should be the same whenever between rounds. Yeah, so a promoter or nobody from the audience shouldn't be able to speak to you.
Right.
I mean, but they're not going to change the rule.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay. I don't think it's a rule for it. That's what I'm saying. I think it needs to be a rule made for it. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Mm. Yep.
Oh, God.
But most definitely should be a rule made for that shit.
It's not going to be. We're asking too much of boxing.
Man, did you see I'm tripping. All day I've been tripping. Damn allergies been having my head hurting and everything else. My latest vid, boxing vid.
Mm-hmm. I did.
I'm telling you, that's going to be a good fight, bro.
It's a dangerous fight for Joshua.
Right.
Because you think Andy can box.
Who's a good box?
He can box and he can take a hit.
And so, the one thing that I love about him, he can box going backwards. He did knock niggas down going back, him walking backwards.
I think the key is to not fight backwards against Joshua. Well, I think you have to mix it up with him.
No, he gonna mix it up. What I'm saying is, though, if he had to go backwards, and for what I'm saying, what's good about people knowing a fight going backwards is this. It becomes a misguided truth. If I'm Anthony and Usyk start going backwards, I'm going to start feeling like I'm getting to him, right? In reality, he could be walking into a hook. You see what I'm saying? Because most fighters don't know how to fight going backwards.
That's true. Flatten his big ass out.
So, but even like I said in the video, even Anthony said though, how he beat Ruiz, he adopted Usyk technique. So that tells me right there that he respect Usyk. While all these other boxers talk shit about Usyk, it came out his own mouth. He said, "I adopted Usyk technique, the sweet science, hit and don't get hit." Mm-hmm. Like fuck a knockout, it's boxing. You know what I'm saying?
It is sad that that man doesn't get the recognition that he is due when it comes to the heavyweight division and boxing.
He just kind of went up. But thing is, they trying to say that he too small. But hey, did nobody say about Deontay? Deontay's small for heavyweight. Deontay should be in bridgeweight or motherfucking cruiserweight.
He should. He'll just be the tallest one. He would have no choice but to try to run the division.
That's why I say he'll probably dominate. He will thrive.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I'm saying.
So could you imagine though a better B versus Deontay Wilder?
Right. That's what I'm saying. He would thrive, yo. Like He should be down that way. You know what I'm saying? But see, Usyk jumped up, said, man, because see, well, people don't know, like I said, Usyk became unified. It wasn't that he cleaned up the division, because see, he kind of got fast-tracked like Andre Ward did. He was in the Super Series, so he had to fight everybody. So, and this was recent over there. He fought everybody and anybody and all the people who had the O's. He beat them all. Ended up being, he took all the belts and became the first unified four belt in the four belt era of that division. So what else is there more for him to do? If you beat every champ and took their belt, of course I'm going to challenge him. If you any type of true champion, you're going to challenge yourself and go up. You see what I'm saying? Yeah. He didn't even hold on to the belts. The nigga just went up like, fuck them belts, man. I'm going to go up. He fought Chisora. People said that his power wasn't going to carry up. He rocked Chisora a couple of times. He didn't put him down, but he dominated that fight. He dominated that fight.
From bell to bell.
So, but a lot of boxers are saying dumb stuff like, well, I don't see Usyk having one-punch power to knock out a 250-pound person. That's not what boxing is about having one-punch power.
And it's not just boxers that are saying it, it's boxing media that's saying it also. Yeah. They have forgotten the true nature of what boxing is.
Right. And I don't know how.
A gentleman's sport. Because they're addicted to the flash, the miraculous KOs, the very dominant performances to where your opponent looks like they didn't win 12 rounds with a brick wall. That's what they fell in love with. And they fell out of love at boxing at its purest form. Moving and showing skill.
Right.
That's what I love about boxing. Being able to be better than the next man just with pure skill alone.
Right.
But that's lost now.
So what got me is like, man, let me restore this chat over here. Thank you. But yeah, like you said, I just don't understand, because like, shit, how you forget when the name of it is called boxing? You know what I'm saying? It's not called two men in a ring, you know, or any of that. And people,
because people are comparing it to UFC.
Well, they better stop it. UFC better be careful. They about to piggyback off a boxing game.
Did Conor win?
I don't know.
Wasn't this fight yesterday or today?
I couldn't even tell you.
Oh, God. Let's see.
That's the thing. They not, and then you notice what PBC doing, right? PBC what? Trying to corner the market. This is their second time putting a fight on a Sunday.
I actually don't have a problem with that.
Me neither. I'm saying it's the second time they did it. And they try to make it where boxing can compete.
Oh, God.
Now, with football, I see this story is going to be a problem, though.
Oh no, it's the fight is July the 10th. My bad. I thought it was this weekend. It's next Saturday.
Yeah.
Man, Dana might be in some trouble with his fighters.
I'm telling you.
Because they're starting to realize how much money is being made outside the octagon compared to inside the octagon. And I think Connor's just doing this for contractual reasons.
Mm-hmm.
I think his mind is really in the squared circle instead of the octagon.
Wouldn't your mind be that nigga made damn near what he made in his whole career in one night?
Now look at what Tyrone Woodley's going to end up making fighting one of the Pauls compared to what he made as his whole run as champion.
Right.
Yeah. I wouldn't be surprised. I wouldn't be surprised if a lot of these veteran fighters just say, forget it. Like, I'm hearing now with Francis Ngannou in the heavyweight championship, I think he's then vacated the belt.
That's crazy. He was just on Mike Tyson thing, I think.
Not too long ago. I think he then vacated the UFC heavyweight belt. I'm not sure about that, but I think he has. Mm-hmm. I think he wants to go into boxing.
Yeah, I think he was on Hot Boxing with Mike Tyson. I ain't watched it, though, yet. He might have been talking about it on there.
Jeez. And this is not saying that there's anything bad with Dana or nothing like that. It's just fighters want to make their money.
Mm-hmm. And Dana got everything. He got to start paying them more, man. And make some rules. You're going to want to get paid more. You're going to have to fight more. To get your name known. You know what I'm saying? Because the thing is, everybody can't be getting paid and don't nobody know who you is. It's like that in boxing, too. Everybody don't make no money in boxing.
No. But I'm starting to see you can get more endorsements in boxing than you can in the UFC.
You can?
That's what it's starting to seem.
Well, when you get a face, you automatically get an endorsement. The gloves you wear, they start paying you for wearing them gloves. The shoes you wear, they start paying you for picking them shoes. Or you get a couple of endorsements off the rip. You know what I'm saying?
So, I don't think Reebok paying like what Nike would.
UFC, all them gloves and all that stuff they use are regulated by UFC, which means they may get the money for saying this shoe ain't going with this brand. You see what I'm saying? Like the NBA chose to go with, who they with? Adidas or something? That make their jerseys now?
I know Jordan down there in Charlotte. He got Nike to make their stuff.
Well, you get what I'm saying, though.
Yeah.
It's not per Adidas individual player.
Uh-huh.
I believe that's how UFC is. If not per individual player, it's like go through Dana and I made a deal with Reebok to give us our gloves and give us our shoes or, you know what I'm saying?
And here's the thing.
And if you don't want to wear this stuff that's sanctioned, you got to pay a fee to wear your brand or, you know what I mean?
That's the unfortunate truth with, you know, having your promoter and your boss be the same person.
Man, that shit should be against the law. That's conflict of interest. That's a conflict of interest. That man holds everybody's life in a balance. They all they career in a hang in a balance.
That is. Did you hear what Floyd Mayweather said about his fight?
Who fight?
About the fight that he had with the Paul brother.
Uh-uh.
He said he got paid to entertain you. That wasn't a fight.
Hell no, it wasn't a fight.
I seen that and I was watching it. I was like, you know what? Good old Floyd. Mm-hmm. Good for you. Good for you.
What he was telling people on, he said it was a legal bank robbery. He told the people he fucked them out of money. On, he said, man, this was a legal bank robbery. Them was his words. So you telling
the that's the video they were talking about. And it wasn't a fight. It wasn't a fight. Oh, because even with bad hands and all, Floyd could have. Look, I don't care what nobody says. There's people trying to disprove it and all this different type of jazz. Mm. Floyd knocked that man out.
And held him up till he woke up. Mm-hmm. He was out.
Because his hands went limp.
His whole body went limp. He laid on Floyd.
And Floyd was backpedaling, holding on to him.
Yeah.
Not even. Because any other time, Floyd would have been throwing punches to the side.
Yep. He was holding him.
Mm-hmm. But people don't want to accept it. Maybe Hey, I don't know.
That, what I think happened was that nigga didn't stick to the game plan when he started running at Floyd and shit. When he started running at Floyd, he started welling on Floyd like that. And Floyd gave him that good enough, like I told your ass now.
And something else, we were covering it. Mm-hmm. We sat there and read the man's lips, and he was telling him, stop throwing the uppercut.
Yeah, he said, stop throwing the uppercut, right. Like, you're trying to hurt me. I'm going to show you I hurt somebody.
And dude looked shook after he said that. Like, he didn't want to get knocked out again. Mm-hmm. But, hey, what can I say? Floyd's a good guy for that.
That's why I said, because he could have said, okay, fuck them rules. I'm about to knock his ass clean fuck out, which he did, but he didn't embarrass that boy.
And people talking about, well, it was bad for boxing and all this stuff. Mm-hmm. I thought that at first. I really did. But then I got a deeper understanding of what was actually going on.
I think it's bad for boxing in the long run. Because if it was just exhibition, that's different. This is WWE you trying to create. What Mike Tyson and Roy did, what he doing is different than what Roy, what Mike Tyson did. Mike Tyson did a true exhibition.
But the thing is, Floyd isn't a sanctioned fighter.
Huh?
Floyd isn't a sanctioned fighter.
He a former pro, though.
Yeah.
He a former pro that fought another pro. But it was scripted, though.
Yeah.
They was talking to each other the whole fight. So you gonna make a WWE version of boxing. In the long run, if the WWE version of boxing paying more than the real version, why fuck with it? Right? That's what I'm talking about in the long run. You know what I'm saying? I'm not talking about that one fight destroyed boxing, you know what I'm saying? But yo, who this?
Yeah.
What's going on, man?
What up? How's everything?
Oh, everything cool. How you say your name, bro?
Have you got any link to watch the fight?
No, not at the moment, but you should go follow over there on GMT Boxing and follow that Yellow Brick Road.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah, for sure, man. Thank
and
you.
Leave a message. All right.
Go, brother.
Well, hello?
Mm-hmm.
That was somebody all the way from England, something where?
The UK?
Shout out to the UK. If you from UK, shout out to you, man.
Shout out to all the international fans, man.
Mm-hmm.
Had a brother hit me up from Jamaica.
That's dope.
Shout out to UK. Shout out to India.
Yeah, I'm right.
For some reason, I got subscribers in India. Shout out to you. Shout out to Philippines. Shout out to Neymar. All those places.
Mm-hmm. The world loves boxing, bro. That's what showed me.
Mm-hmm.
The world loves boxing.
If you love the sweet science, come on over, man. All doors are welcome. All of that, man. With love. Let me see. Is it going to be? I need to check something. It might be an issue.
Hmm.
It might be an issue.
What?
With the Yellow Brick Road.
Oh, for real?
I don't think that they're going to.
They may not be showing it.
Oh. Might not be big enough.
Mm. That's the only thing I got.
The only thing I got it can come up with.
You know what I mean?
Oh, God. So the fight, the show or whatever should be starting in the next 6 minutes.
Yeah, because this fight can be done.
Hey.
They tricked me, though. I thought the fight didn't come on. I was looking like, did I hit the, because you know, I got DVR and stuff. Like, did I hit the DVR? And I was like, hold on, I didn't buy this fight. I'm like, the hell? You know what I'm saying? Like, what's going on?
Mm-hmm. You know, that would be really good for a breakdown.
Oh, this fight? And rewatching this fight, this man got touched up, but I'm going to tell you something. I got to give to him. Tank got a tough-ass face.
Yeah. I mean, you don't get the name Tank for nothing.
Right. Hey, he doing what he supposed to, because he took the punishment. He, like I said, just who wanted it more?
My whole issue was with Barrios. I still don't understand what the hell was exactly the game plan.
They showing it right now when he made knocked him into the ropes in round 9. Cause round 9 was Barrios. You know he got knocked down twice in the 8th round.
Mm-hmm.
Round 9 was here. I thought he was gonna come out round 10 strong. You know what I'm saying?
I thought he was too. It was actually kind of depressing.
Yeah.
To where it almost looked as staged or whatever, like a Mayweather event. It just had that feel to it. Like, bro, you are not Rudy.
But now looking at it, he's swinging with everything, but Tank studied walking through, taking punches and walking through it just to get close to him. I think Tank knew he had to knock him out. Tank knew.
Poor Maria.
The way it looked now, like watching it again, Tank eating a lot of punches to get this knockout.
Unnecessary shots.
Yeah. He just walking through it. He studied getting jabbed up in the face. But Tank just walking through it to get close to knock this dude out.
You know, after watching the fight and then watching the highlights again, and you're watching the fight now, you know, a boxer's brain can only take so much. Do you see him having a very long career?
No, I don't think that's the plan. I think the little dude wants, because he always complaining how they doing him and stuff. I think he wants to, I think he's trying to find a home. I actually thought like maybe he's just using it as a money grab. They want to use this as a money grab where he can go down and up and down and up. I think Tank trying to find a home. If Tank find a home 140, I'd do good. Tank trying to get the biggest fight so he can go on and, you know, retire. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Because at the end of the day, all sports have figured that out now. Football was first. When you saw Keyshawn Johnson, and one day they said, I retired. And he was like, what? What is he retiring for? You know what I'm saying? And from there on, you got Beast Mode. It was people before Beast Mode that played like 10 years and stacked their money and retired, you know?
Calvin Johnson.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
That hurt.
Yeah.
That hurt.
Yeah. So you get what I'm saying, though? Like, it's people that figure their sport out, man. If why not? That's why I think Bud wants these big fights and get him out the way. He just don't want to retire like he didn't do nothing. You know what I'm saying? Like, you think he's going to look at his record and be like, my record should look way better than this. You know what I'm saying? My list of fighters should look way better than this, but it's not his fault. I think that's why he waiting out. He want to fight the big dudes, so whenever he ready to retire, they can't say he didn't fight the big dudes of his era. You get what I'm saying?
Uh-huh.
You know, but these cats is like now, like, because the norm, to be honest with you, it's normal to now, let me say it like this. It's like in boxing, your career don't start until you get 30, until you got the 30 fights. It's like we just not meeting you at 30 fights, 28 fights or something like that, unless you super good. You get what I'm saying? If you super good, like Vasily Lomachenko, we going to see you at like your 14th fight. 12th fight. You get what I'm saying? If you in his boots, we go see you in your early fights. If you David, hey, we go, you know what I'm saying? You gotta be that type of special. Other than that, it seems like the norm is you see a nigga on TV, he like 25, 26, 27, 28 fights and zero. You get what I'm saying? And then people like, who is this? You know what I mean? And then he fight maybe 10 more fights. You see him, and they usually be about to, they should be against the good comp. You get what I'm saying? They should be against the good competition, and then they will retire. Hence, can you name any fights? Okay, we talking about Errol Spence right now. Before Mikey Garcia, can you name somebody? Well, who did he fight? Wait a minute. He did fight somebody before Mike Garcia. Who was that? Because it was Sean Porter.
Yeah. Okay,
before Sean Porter, who, can you remember that person?
No.
All right, then. Now go look up what his record was. Now go look up what his record was before Sean Porter. Then you'll see what I mean.
The only thing I know is the let's see. The first time I seen him like on a PBC main event card was in Jerry World, and he stopped a dude with a body shot.
Uh-huh.
And that was about 2 years, two, maybe three years ago now.
No, that was about 5-6 years. I remember that. No, it wasn't even his fight when I saw him. It was his fight, but it wasn't his card. You get what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
And he stopped dude in the top right at the angle they was on. He stopped him at the top right corner. I mean, top left corner with a body shot. It was a last knockout.
Yeah.
Folded up. But if you go look before Sean Porter, I will even give him the fight before that. Nobody remembers those fights.
No.
Because then nobody know who no people were. This is why we say when they say Errol fought some, but Errol got a better resume. Well, he's fought at the people of his era. And two of these guys, I'm going to be real with you, he was way bigger than them. And that was Mike Garcia and Kell Brook. People say Kell Brook was bigger than him. I didn't see that.
They looked about the same size.
Well, to me, Errol was more wide and muscular. You know what I'm saying? And he showed he was physically stronger. Yeah, that's it. Fight over.
The difference between muscle weight and just putting on pounds.
Right. No, I know.
It looked like Brooke just put on pounds.
Yeah, right. So you get what I'm saying, though? So it's like, that's what I'm saying. So when you go back, that's like when you really meet the nigga. And then now he won't take on the comp. But it's common for these cats to have 25 fights of fluff. Right? If you want to say it that way. Now, I have to see if they mandatory. You got to see what they is. But the point is, won't we know who them niggas is?
That's true. That's true.
I be trying to tell everybody that, like, if you put them type of resumes, say, go back to the name that you know, right? The last name on a person's resume you know, right? Now, do this. You want to know what's crazy? You could do that with Sean Porter and him. Quiet kept Sean Porter resume be neck and neck with him there.
No.
You want to know why?
Why?
Because he done fought everybody. He done down there fought everybody in his era. Can you say the same thing about Earl?
No.
Right.
You can't say that, but I can't say that they resumes are neck and neck.
Okay, who got the better resume?
Porter.
Oh, okay. I thought you said that way around.
No. I probably just misspoken, but I think Sean Porter has the better. He has Keith Thurman. Doesn't he have Danny Garcia also?
Yeah. He fought.
He fought everybody.
He ain't fought. Yeah, he fought Thurman. No, I don't think he fought Danny. Damn, I'm about to have me look this shit up. Did he fight Danny? Goddamn me.
Let me see.
Look it up for me, fam. So I have to rearrange my windows.
Let me see.
What's going on, everybody, man? If you haven't, hit that like button, man. Hit that like button. Rob, what's going on? Hit that like button. Hit that share button if you're new. Make sure you hit the
sub. Yes, he did. He fought Danny Garcia.
Yeah, see? That's what I'm saying. The man fought everybody. I don't care if he lost or not. The man can say he fought everybody, but don't nobody want to give him a round two. that speak volumes. Sometimes motherfuckers, somebody don't make sense. That's a lie. It don't make sense for you to go through that punishment again. Say that. It don't make sense. Yeah, for you to go through that punishment. Cause I would love, and the people even said they would love to see a Sean Porter. Like after this Pacquiao fight, say Earl win. Nigga, I would love to see a Sean Porter and Earl Spence. You know what I'm saying? And then he fight Bud. Man, shit.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I just knew that was gonna go down, fam. I just knew that was gonna go down.
Sean Porter, man. Sean Porter. Jesus Christ, Sean Porter. I'm looking at his fight. Jesus Christ, man. Jeez. Oops. Sammy Sparkman.
Huh?
Jamar Patterson.
Uh-huh.
Jerome Ellis. Lamar Harris. I know who some of these fighters are. Yeah. Russell Jordan. Hector Munoz. Patrick Thompson. Oh my. Julio Diaz.
I know. You know, you know who Julio Diaz is.
Yeah, he fought him twice.
That's what I'm saying, bro. If you was to put his stuff Holly on paper, Marlin. Now put stuff on paper don't make him a better boxer than Errol. But if you would look on paper, his resume look pretty goddamn good, right? Also, look how many times he's been champion. How many times he's been champion?
Jesus
Christ. So, like, if you was to put his stuff on paper, you'd be like, damn, sure. You'd be like, Errol, he's the truth. You feel me?
Mm-hmm.
You'd be like, he's the truth. Sean is the truth. Not Errol, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know what I'm saying? So I'm just being real. That's why I always tell people about Pacquiao. Pacquiao resume. Go look up Pacquiao resume, man. Look how many times Pacquiao been fighter of the year.
Birdo.
Huh?
I didn't know this dude fought Birdo. Yeah.
Go look up. Go after you get done. Look up Pacquiao resume.
And Adrian Broner.
Yeah. And okay, Adrian Broner had dropped Sean in that fight too. I remember that shit too. It was like a flash knockdown.
God damn, man. Manny Pacquiao. Jesus, I wish, man, that would have been something else to see Manny versus Sean.
Boy, a Manny versus Sean? Boy, that'd be more of a war.
That would be more entertaining.
Bro, on my mama. And some people like, no, I don't want to see that. Like, get the hell out. That right there would be for the fans, like everybody, like
that's a fan question.
Oh my mom!
That is specifically for the fans. God. Oh God! See, he fought Tim Bradley Jr. twice, no, three times. Shane Mosley, Tony Margarito. Cotto, Hatton, De La Hoya, David Diaz, Marco Antonio Barrera, Jorge Solis, Eric Morales.
Who you looking at?
Manny Pacquiao.
Oh, man, I ain't talking about that. I'm talking about, like, go look up his accolades. Like, look up how many times he's been Fighter of the Year and shit like that. Shit. How many times he's been champion. We know he ate division, but look up how many times he been champion? How many times, like, if you write all that shit down there and put it, then look up Mayweather's, you be like, Mayweather ain't do half the shit this nigga done did. That's what I be saying, like, if you was to put shit on paper, stuff look backwards in the motherfucker. But that's what make boxing what it is. Because, see, one thing about boxing, you can look at the paperwork, but also that don't mean the paperwork don't balance out what you see in the ring sometimes. You get what I'm saying? Sometimes that don't make that person a better boxer. You get what I mean? So, like I said, only basketball, football, all those sports be lying. Because, like I said, they be like, oh, my God. Slick 50 was, like, the best free throw shooter last year. He shot 100%. Nigga only shot one free throw, though. Right? But they ain't going to say that. Am I lying? Am I lying? They were like, he's 75% from the line. He only shot the ball 6 times last year, bro. Like, you get what I'm saying? Like, but that makes him sound so good. Huh?
But that's the thing, though. It's easy to come up with stats to prove your argument. It's easy to come up with things for that because everything else pretty much discredits everything that you're saying.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Pacquiao was named Fighter of the Decade for the 2000s by the Boxing Writers Association of America, World Boxing Council, and World Boxing Organization in 2006, 2008, 2009. He was awarded Ring Magazine, ESPN, and BWAA Fighter of the Year. And in 2009 and in 2011, he won Best Fighter, ESPY Award. BoxRec ranks him as the greatest Asian fighter of all time. In 2016, Pacquiao ranks number 2 on ESPN's list of top pound-for-pound boxers of the past 25 years. And he ranks number 5 in BoxRec's ranking of greatest pound-for-pound boxers of all time.
I mean, did you see how many times Boxer of the Year?
Boxer of the Year, 6 times.
Mm-hmm. But everybody won't hold on to an O when other boxers have done that. All right. I'm just saying, though. Just saying, bro. And the man that said he got an O, that got that O, that 50-0, he even said his toughest fight was who?
Pacquiao.
But we want to see the best fight the best. But he sat there and fought old boy twice. What's his name? The one that beat the AB?
Was it Margarito? Margarito? No, it wasn't Margarito. No,
But he went on punk, though. We knew what type of fight it was going to be, but damn, what was his name? Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, the world's sixth. God.
But he didn't get Pacquiao a second.
Golly. Forbes lists Pacquiao as world's equal 6th highest paid athlete with a total of 40 million or 2 billion pesos for the second half of 2008 and the first half of 2009, tying him on the 6th spot with NBA player LeBron James and golfer Phil Mickelson. Pacquiao was again included in Forbes' list of highest paid athletes for the second highest total earnings in 2009 and 2010. He was
See, he can't talk that money. That was saying it was equals. He couldn't even talk that money talk with Pacquiao. You hear me? Pacquiao owned the country, nigga.
ESPN magazine report that Pacquiao was one of the 2 top earning athletes in 2016 alone. Ahead of golly, bro, he made more money than Alex Rodriguez, bro.
Right, that's crazy.
Oh my God. 71 fights. He has 71 fights.
Yeah, who got 71 fights?
Pacquiao.
On his pro record? Not pro record.
Professional record summary. It says 71 fights, 62 wins, 7 losses.
Oh, okay. You added all together. I'm thinking wins. Okay, I got you.
Uh-huh. 62 wins and 7 losses. Listen, young fighters, that O don't mean nothing. The O doesn't mean anything. Add one more to that because of the Floyd. Well, no, they got that on here. Never mind. But yeah, bro. He only has two draws in his whole career.
What'd you say?
He only has two draws in his whole career.
Yeah, yeah. And they was worthy draws at that, though. They were worthy. They were worthy.
Juan Manuel Marquez was one.
Yep. That's why they kept playing.
Agapito Sanchez was the other.
Man, like
I said, that's somebody else that people forget about in the throes of history.
There's a whole bunch of them, people back then that at the mercy, especially Mexican boxers back then. Like, if y'all know who Alexis Arguello is, go check his fights out, bro. Beast. It's a whole bunch of Latino and Mexican boxers and got lost in the sauce. You know what I'm saying? So to speak, that were monsters, like just straight monsters, bro.
Like, people forget about Melvin Magrimo too.
Mm-hmm.
Magrimo was a good dude. He was good.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It's just a lot of people they don't know. Like, but that's the thing that's good about boxing. Boxing don't never get old, bro. It's only old until you saw that fight. So if this fight you ain't never seen, watch it. That's what I tell people. Like, it's plenty of fights. Like, especially when I see a new boxer, trust me, like we just said, 9 times 10, you don't see a boxer they hit like 25 under their belt as a pro most of the time. Go back and look for their other fights.
Mm-hmm.
Go back and look for the other fights. You'll be amazed. And then you'll be like, then you'll be like, okay, now I see why they saying he a beast. You feel me?
You know, have you noticed Pacquiao has not fought another Mexican fighter since 2012?
Well, who was there for him to fight?
There was plenty of Mexican fighters he could have fought, but
I mean, Ford, at that moment, at that top peak in his career, though, like I said, look at the peak of his career, though, everything had to make sense for that man. You got to think about it. He was running for Congress. He was before he was Congress, he was aide to the consul or something, some shit like that, right? Then he ran for Congress. Now he ran for president. You know what I'm saying? It had to make sense for him to take off that time, like when he fought when he was damn, I just said it. Consular, whatever, or just senator, whatever. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
He had to take time off of that shit. You know what I mean? And balance. Jeez. So it's not like he can just do that. You know what I'm saying? He was doing a lot. Not to mention, at one point in time, you know, a lot of people don't know, like, he had to stop drinking and shit. That was nothing. Meanwhile, he was putting people ass while he was kind of an alcoholic at the same time. Nigga would be drunk in the gym.
And something else, he's very devout in his faith. So he wasn't destroying people the way that he could have because he didn't think that it would be Christianly to knock somebody out.
Yeah, he said that. He said, why? He said, if I know I could... He said, if I know I can beat you, why knock you out? Why knock you out? I'll never forget that shit. Because everybody was like, is this power gone? He ain't knocked nobody out. I don't know how long. But that's during the era when he was an alcoholic and his wife threatened to divorce him because he owned a whole lot of pool halls, a whole lot of bars. He owned a whole lot of everything, grocery stores in the Philippines. So she was like, he can go drink everywhere, and then the women will be all over him and everything. She threatened to divorce him. And that's when he renewed his faith and got back in church. And every Wednesday, he started having church in his gym, his boxing gym now.
Mm-hmm.
And that was during that time when he was like, I shouldn't be knocking people out just for the sport. I should just, you know, if I can win, I'm going to win or whatever. It was during that era. But he said that sometime he'll be drunk in the gym training, and nobody knew. That's crazy.
Yeah.
That's what you call the drunken master for real. And I was trying to be funny. The drunken style for real, boy. But was in there drunk training. Steep.
But I was just sitting here looking at the names on his record, man.
No, I was telling people, man, just look at it. Look it up. And then people you don't know that boxing is one of them rabbit holes, man. It's all right to fall down in, man. Go look at some of the people on his record. Go look them fights up. Look who they fought. You know what I'm saying? It's crazy. Jeez. Look up who that fighter fought last before Pacquiao. You know what I'm saying? And then it'll shock you. Then like, damn, like what? Like, that's what I be trying to say. And then and I'm gonna tell you something. Sometimes be the names you don't know. You be like, this nigga fought who? Shane Mosley. He fought who? Da da da. He fought dude. Hey man, what is you creeping up? What are you doing? Did he scare the mess out of me, little girl?
I wonder. See, and people. Another thing that people don't know.
Right.
He has a brother that boxed.
Oh yeah, Sammy. Yeah, Sammy. Yeah, he stopped, but he boxed during the same time. He was all right. He wasn't the best, but I mean he wasn't garbage though.
He was not garbage.
But he trained now. Sammy trained now. Mm-hmm. Yeah, Sammy he wasn't bad at all, but he trained now.
Mm-hmm. See, man, that's Pacquiao has, you know. I would love to see a young fighter, a young American fighter. He shouldn't have to. I'm going to say that first off. He shouldn't have to. But go across the water and train with Pacquiao. Learn from him. Imagine what that would do to that young man's stock.
Who? Which one? Who?
Just say, for instance, a young American fighter, up-and-coming fighter, went and trained or had Manny train him in the Philippines.
Manny had time. Everybody meant to be a trainer, but I think he could do it. If anybody can, I think he could. He could. I think Manny, man, just like Manny, one of the people where he not worried about legendary status and all the extracurricular stuff until after it's over. You get what I'm saying? Like, I'm not gonna stop.
Yeah, that's true. Because we have a tendency to talk about legacy when, you know, legacy is something that should be talked about when you're retired or dead.
Yeah, like, I don't think he worried about that stuff until the day he fully retired. Then he'll accept all that or hear all that, you know?
Mm-hmm.
That's how I feel like I think, because then you're not hungry no more. If you already talking about you a legend, you this, you that, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
That sounds like retirement talk. Like, you ready to just sit down.
It sounds like you don't have to do it anymore.
Yeah, you know what I mean? I think this fight, if anything, gonna wake up and bring the best out of Pacquiao, because, shoot, this is him kind of going back in reverse to thinking he's young Manny. He's taking on a young cat. You know what I'm saying? Being the age he is, that's huge. People not realizing the gratification of it. Like, they just like, oh, this is a big fight, but bruh, granted, he don't got nothing to lose, but at the same time, he got everything to gain. If he win this, that's unheard of, bruh. Legend is being a legend would be, I mean, he's a legend already, but there would be no question of why he's a legend.
If he wins, that sets the bar even higher for Canelo.
Oh, hell yeah. Yeah, but I don't know, man. Canelo screamed names. I think he's seen. I think he want to fight. Now he want to fight Benavidez. I think he don't want to fight Plant. Now he's talking about Benavidez. Give me Benavidez. Yeah, I bet you want to say that. I told you he don't like people who can fight with speed, bro. He don't like that. Mm-hmm. Now you talking about you looking at Benavidez. No, dang well, y'all been talking about this fight.
Oh, and with Baraki said the easiest fight for him to win would be against Charlo.
Yeah, he was. He said, "Who he tell come on?" He told Earl to come up too. He said he want Earl to go ahead and come up.
You know what? I love Earl. I do, but I think that'd be a bad idea.
Oh no, that's gonna be a crazy inside fight, because that's what's gonna be the whole night. Look, go on down, sir. Watch TV. You're doing too much.
Look, the way I look at it, if he ain't gonna get Sean Porter another run, ain't no way in hell he gonna fight Pacquiao. I mean, not Pacquiao, but Canelo. And plus, I don't see Earl fighting too much longer anyway.
No, I don't think Earl wants to. I'll be honest with you, man. I don't think he ever gonna be 100%. I think that did something to him mentally. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's just too much playing, bro. Like, But it's going to tell in this fight, like I said, this is the bigger paycheck than the Bud Crawford fight. I can't deny that. It is a bigger paycheck. So why not go on and get it? Because if you think it in that mindset, let me go and get this retirement check. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Let me go and get win, lose, a legend whoop my ass. Okay. You know what I'm saying? Same way Canelo. Hey, that one loss is to Mayweather, dog. So, you know what I'm saying? It wasn't by no Rudy Poo-Cat. Right, exactly. So, hey, let me get this check, bro. I wish you would say who whooped my ass. It was Pacquiao, motherfucker. It wasn't you. You know what I'm saying? So.
I would love to see that roundtable discussion with Pacquiao, Canelo, and Floyd.
That'd be crazy, man. I mean, that's lessons, man. Like, for real. What if Floyd? See, I don't understand. This dude got a monster armband on. Are you watching this? I don't like that. You know what that damn monster sign? Made to look like an M, but those, I forgot what language it is. 666. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And he just got it on for no reason. It's like a armband he got on, but he got a whole suit on. That's weird. But anyway, but no, like. Like I said, then what if Earl don't quit? And if he get beat by Pacquiao afterwards, going on a mean streak, laying everybody out.
But here's the thing, though. In that process, he's gonna have to see Terrence.
No, yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah. That's why I said I want to get a fight in between it. I don't want to go from a Pacquiao to no. To know, Bud, for one, if he lose, that's the first thing he gonna say. Man, I just came off the fight of my life with Pacquiao, then I fought Bud. I don't want to hear that. I don't want to hear that. Go on, pick another fight in between. You know what I'm saying? Go on.
Who could he fight though?
Sean.
See, and then that would be another built-in excuse. Sean,
but he
really
made,
does
but he made it work. Where but he made it where you can't, because after the fight, he swore to God like it was one of the easiest things he went through. Now I knew he was gonna come. I already knew he was gonna come rush me. I was already prepared for that. I would remember that. You can't backtrack from that
in the post fight.
Right? You made it seem like it was easy. You see what I'm saying? So go get that easy money.
If that was the case, then he should have gave Sean his rematch.
Yeah, for real. It should have happened. That should have happened.
Ooh. I don't see him. I don't see him taking any risk. I really don't. I don't see him taking any fight after this Pacquiao fight that's going to detriment his quote unquote legacy or career. I don't see it.
I don't know. He don't want to fight Keith Thurman. I will fight Keith. He can fight Keith Thurman. I would fight.
I wouldn't fight Keith Thurman if I was him because of the way Keith did him.
Man, look, this is boxing. That's some personal shit. I would just do it just to get him out the way. I'll take all that personal shit. See, that's the difference from now back in the day. You think Hagler didn't like nobody? He fought everybody, though.
It's not about fact of liking or not. It's the fact that he said that he would not fight him.
I get that. Whoop his ass and make him feel like he should have gotten that in. Because he's begging for it now. Take that and make something out of it. Don't be the same as him. You know what I'm saying? You ain't doing to make the same mistake. You canceling yourself out of a check. Just because
who I could see him fighting.
Huh?
Want to tell you who I could see Earl fighting?
Who?
AB.
Oh, that would be garbage. That would be garbage. Earl going to beat the hell up, man. Look. Nah, man. I'd rather see Keith Thurman, bro. I'm being real, man. Cause you know what? I would tell Keith Thurman, I'm gonna beat your ass and make you wish you had fought me earlier. When you should have. Now you waited till I'm seasoned. I'm about to beat the fuck out of you. You know what I'm saying? That's what I would tell Keith Thurman. You should have gave me my shot when I told you to give me my shot. Now beat your ass.
All that is dependent on what happens in this fight.
Oh, yeah, 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 yeah.
If Earl loses, he doesn't have a leg to stand on.
Oh, no, but it'll be a Keith Thurman fight. It'll be a Keith Thurman, Sean. It'll be a Shine, Keith Thurman, and then a Bud, because he got to build that back up. And I ain't going to lie, I still want to see the Bud fight, even if he do lose. If he lose, because that's just a perfect, you know, style make fights. They just synonymous. They pose the fight. I don't care if he lose to Pacquiao. That fight got to happen. That's going to be one of the most special fights ever to happen, dude. That's going to be ridiculous. Because, you know, both of them, they're going to fight. You know what I'm saying? They going to come.
But imagine how the roles were reversed, though.
Huh?
Because now Spence would need Bud.
Yeah, Bud ain't going to sell it. But that's one thing about Bud. Bud ain't going to sell it, but I bet you it'll sell itself. All people got to do is actually see contract being signed. People going to go crazy. Just like, be honest with you, the Tyson, they ain't did nothing to sell this Tyson Fury fight.
They really haven't.
But they sold out.
The thing that sold it was arbitration.
Yeah, they just sold it out. You know what I'm saying? So, I mean, you know what I mean? And if people put the camera on Bud more, you'll catch more out of Bud. You know what I'm saying? Bud, humble, surreal. Bud be like, fuck that nigga. You know what I'm saying? Catch him saying shit like that. That'll hype people up. Just catch him being himself. That's all he want to be. He don't want to be. Well, y'all saw the thing I showed y'all. He don't want to be out there faking it. Like, oh, fuck this nigga. Woo, woo. You know what I'm saying? Just to sell a fight. Just catch him in a real conversation. Like, man, I don't give a fuck about nobody who I fight. Because we're going to get in the ring. Like, it is what it is. That's the beauty of Bud. Because he know when to turn it on and cut it off. You know what I'm saying? Ain't no getting under the skin. Right. It ain't no getting any under his skin. He know how to turn his anger into action. You know what I'm saying?
Well, there was one person that made him angry, and he he regretted it.
What was the dude's name? He was a friend of something, Paul, some shit like that. When he talked about his daddy or something, and Bud kept coming out with earbuds in. He wasn't even listening to nobody. He just told him, beat your motherfucking ass. And then when he knocked him out, he said, you get what you wanted, nigga. He got what you wanted, nigga. Yeah, that was when, I never forget. If it wasn't for that fight, I'll be honest with you. I think that was the fight that catapulted Bud, because people was wondering, did he have a mean streak in him? Mm-hmm. We knew he could box, because before that, remember he had the dreads, little short dreads and shit. And we knew he could box, you know what I'm saying, his ass off. But people didn't know if he had a mean streak into that fight. Boy, he put hands on that man.
Why should that have to be a requirement to be a great fighter?
What, a mean streak?
Yeah.
Well, it makes more entertaining if a person make it personal. You know what I'm saying? But I like what I saw. I like that he stayed on his square. He just raised the intensity level up. You get what I'm saying? Like, you made this mistake. It didn't turn around and be a mistake on him. That's why dude said it. He thought he was going to get on his skin, and Bud was just going to be, you know, irate about it. And, you know, if you mad in the ring, you can't think. You know what I'm saying? You know, it's like Bud. I think Bud was kind of coasting, like what Pacquiao said. Why knock you out if I know I could beat you just winning? You know what I'm saying? And you cross that line. Okay, I can get you out of here. I'm going to show you. You know what I mean? That's what I got out of it. You know, he didn't look like the angry goon where he just welling and he was just swinging irate like Deontay Wilder. You know what I'm saying? He upped the productivity. He went from 30 jabs to 60 jabs. You know what I'm saying? On your ass. He went from 10 landing 10 hooks to 30 hooks. You know what I mean? Like, he just upped the productivity on you and let you know, like, if I want to get you out of here, guess what? I can get you out of here, you know.
Because he was not playing with that man from the opening bell.
Hell no, he was not. Hell
no. I remember that. I remember that fight.
And ain't no man talk shit to Bud since. Ain't no man talk shit to Bud since.
You know what? I want to see Sean Porter get a mean streak and start saying fuck Bud.
Man, I've been saying that forever. This dude is the most lovable cat. Man, I respect. He respect everybody and this and that. But I do give it to him though. He get a ring though. It ain't what he say don't match it. But if he get a mean streak, like fuck the world, nigga. I promise to God, that's gonna be some. You think he fight crazy now?
Oh, I just want to see Sean Porter just one day go to the barbershop, cut them braids off, throw on a do-rag, and put a toothpick in his mouth with a white
nigga like an old gangster.
Be like, I don't give a damn about none of these niggas.
Right. Hey, but nah, why I picture that crying when he get mad? And they get to crying in the ring when he get mad, nigga. He sound like old boy on Harlem Nights. Quick!
Can't do that.
Quick!
And he can't do that.
He get to welling on niggas. And niggas going nuts, welling on with them overhand rights, overhand lefts. I'm sick of the job with him, motherfucker.
I'm sick of this shit. I can't stand you, nigga.
I'm tired of that with him. He's always trying to knock me down in the 11th round. Hey, that shit would be hilarious, bro. I mean,
oh my God.
You can't tell me it wouldn't. Say what? What's going on, man? Marcos Madonna. Yes, I haven't been looking at chat. Forgive me, y'all. My bad. Yeah, Rob in the house. Yeah, that was Madonna, who we was trying to think of, who Floyd fought twice.
Oh my God.
Man, say what? What's going on? My bad. We've been here just chopping up, laughing like a mother. Hit that like button for your boy one time. I wish these damn.
I can see Bud on a do-rag going in a cigarette in his mouth talking about, I don't give a damn about Spence.
Right.
I don't care. Spencer's. Spencer Rattle, Spencer Ware, Spencer,
right,
Spencer Beal, fuck all the Spence and the Spencers. I don't give a damn.
Riviera, he got some speed, bro. Riviera got some speed. I only seen him one other time with the Ali shorts on. He's only seen him one other time. I've never seen this Fernandez kid.
Mm-hmm.
He got King Joffer on the back. On the back is no, I think it say Joffer though. I thought it said Joffer.
Joffrey.
Yeah, Joffrey. I thought it said
he got Joffrey on the back.
I thought it said that, but it don't. It say Joffer.
Oh,
and then on the front is short. It's a J. His symbol is a J with a crown on top of it. Yeah, it say Joffer. J O N F E R. I thought it said Joffrey. You know,
if you was a fighter, what would your persona be, man?
Boy, shit, just me and my, this kid don't talk. That's how it was anyway. I'd get in there and do my do. I didn't care what you said to me, just get in there and show it.
Nigga, I ain't gonna lie. I would only fight in the winter.
But I talk shit while I fight, though. Like James Toney. That's what I used to like about James Toney.
I would only fight in the winter. I'd be the Ice King.
The Ice King, hell no.
Or the Night King. Winter is coming.
Right.
Whatever you heard, winter is coming.
Hey, that should be hard. I ain't going to stunt, though. Like, if you became a boxing star and you took over the wintertime, like, they only fight during the wintertime. Wintertime come, they will know, too. Oh, it's about to be winter. You know what's coming. Winter is coming. Like, yo, they'll promote the shit out of that, dog. They will promote the shit out of that. That would be hard. I ain't gonna stunt.
Soon as September hits, what would it say? 60 days?
Hell or
90
yeah.
days? 90 days. Ooh. Until winter.
He starts Fernandez's legs. Boy, go ahead, Riviera, run in. He out there looking like Ali. This dude, hey, tell me why Riviera got a box like Ali and everything, though. He got Ali trunks on. No lie, he got and it say Ali on the front, and his name, his last name in the back, Ali Riviera. And then, but it's the same white and black trunks that Ali wore. He got black gloves on, and he got a box like Ali did back in the day with all white shoes. That dude must really look up to Ali on everything.
Well, to have a name like that. That kind of brings some pressure.
Hey, he got some nice defense though. He got caught a couple times, but he got some nice D. Like I said, I only saw him a couple. I mean, one other time. They was trying to compare him to like Felix Trinidad and stuff like that. You people say what? He got the box and everything. He got the whole Halloween costume on.
He's cosplaying as Ali.
Yeah, man. He got the hair piece on and everything, man. You better be careful, dude. Don't knock it off, though.
Knock it to pay off.
Yeah, man. Pull up to the scene with your ceiling missing. Can't be doing that.
Oh, God. Man, hey, I'm just sitting here thinking about it. That would be my rename, the Ice King. The Ice King.
That should be hard. I ain't going to say that would be hard, bro. You know how many endorsements you can get from that?
My first fight, I come out dressed like Sub-Zero, dude.
Hell no, you stupid. You stupid motherfucker, bro. The nigga say you gonna come out like Sub-Zero. Ooh, shoot. Old boy Fernandez caught his ass. But, ooh, okay. Fernandez got some fight in him. And he would say he gonna come out like Sub-Zero. No, I come out like old boy every time. On whatchamacallit, Game of Thrones, nigga. Mm-hmm. This is a fight right here, dog. This is a straight up fight. Oh boy, trying to look too pretty though. I ain't gonna stunt.
Ali did most of the stuff that he did out of necessity.
Yeah, this thing trying to look a little too pretty. He looked like Ali, just not a slick. Yeah, right. Say what? Right. He got some nice. Ooh, that was a nice overhand right. But he got some good defense, and he just doing too much and not no swinging. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. But I like his shorts though. I ain't gonna, man, they should let you buy boxing shorts and shit. See, that's another thing that need to be brought into boxing, man. These kids don't get to make money off their likeness. Like, you do you know, like on certain contracts, like they can't sell their clothing. Like after a fight, they can't sell their boxing shorts, they can't sell the gloves, they can't, do you know that?
Yeah, because the commission owns it.
Yeah, so like, you know, things like that, like they should be able to do that shit. You hear me?
Off their own memorabilia.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Because I like to buy them shorts off Riviera. Like, if he had a website and, like, them shorts, them boxer shorts, hard, bro. I'd walk around the boxer shorts before I walk around basketball shorts if I could buy them like that. Just because I like boxing. You get what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
That's just me, though.
I'm still thinking about this shit.
Yeah, nah, man, that should be hard, bro. Nigga, you had the biggest Starbucks deal. You had the biggest Starbucks deal. You know, by iced coffee.
Somebody bring your make it snow in the whole arena when I'm walking out.
That should be hard, nigga. Motherfucker talking about bring your ass out on a sled and shit.
Nigga,
that should be crazy.
Ice cream nigga playing in the background.
That should be crazy. Nah, yeah, hell no, nah. You be the ice man, then come out the ice cream man. That type of shit. Master Pecan, Master P.
Yeah.
That should be hard, bro. That's why I applaud Tank. He got his brand going on. Right. They got to start that shit early, bro. But at the same time, though, it would be nice if they could just take those shorts and, like, put them on their own website and auction them off for, like, cancer sucks and shit like that. You get what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
That's the type of stuff I be thinking about. I wouldn't be selfish. Like, Ali Riviera, I probably buy his shorts, have him signed, put him up. You never know, he might become a star. You know what I'm saying? But say we get some gloves signed by Pacquiao, which may happen, so stay tuned, y'all. We trying to get gloves signed by Errol Spence and Pacquiao while we're out there. I don't know why I ain't been saying that shit. But
matter of fact, if you can, come out to Vegas. It's
going down. It's going down, y'all. It's going down. For real, for real. But so we get that. Like, I wouldn't keep it to myself. I ain't gonna lie. Now, if I want two gloves each, because I do want one. But I would want one glove with Earl and Manny on her. I don't have a problem with that. You get what I'm saying? But if I get multiples and stuff, I would auction that shit off, bro. No lie. Try to partner up with somebody like Cancer Sucks or somebody else that could match it and then go to a charity or something like that and do it right here on YouTube, bro. Stuff like that pull money out of people's pockets, especially rich people. You know what I'm saying?
You know, the St. Jude's for the cancer research for children. And,
yeah.
You know,
yeah, like my daughter, she got sickle cell. So I would definitely like to do one for kids with SS. You know what I'm saying?
And then do one, like, I would love to do one for kids with autism.
Yeah, right. You know what I'm saying? Stuff like that. you know,
my son has autism, so I would love to do something like that for that.
Right, and these guys don't get a shot to do that. They like Mayweather, all MGM on all of Mayweather's. If I ain't mistaken, Rob, if you in here, correct me. Don't Mayweather MGM own all of Mayweather's entrance uniforms and shit?
See, stuff like that, man. Somebody would put,
that's millions sitting in a glass case. That's what I'm saying. Yeah. Like that's the type of stuff. Like, you know, if I get my hands on, I'll be looking at this shit. And these little dudes will give you their shoes. It's nothing to a boxer. Like, here, dude, give you their boxing shoes, sign them. You know what I'm saying? Things like that, man. Dude, think about how many. Hey, peep this. Has anybody thought about this? Think about how many kids that was at a Lakers game and Kobe gave them his shoes. You know what some shoes worth? That's a college education now.
And I'm pretty sure those people aren't even giving that stuff up.
So I'm just saying, bro. Michael Jordan just released about 3 weeks ago. I don't know if y'all was hip. He signed a bunch of Bred 11s. Michael Jordan did, and was selling them $25,000 a piece on upperdeck.com. Because remember I told you, he Upper Deck owned his name. Go on there. I ain't lying. $25,000. But these guys should be able to own their own stuff like that, too. Like, that's what I'm saying. Like, have y'all ever had a favorite fighter and be wishing all their fights was on DVD? You can't find that shit nowhere. Like, I would love to have all of Mike Tyson fights, bro. Like, every single fight. But you can't find that shit. It's too many people. Oh, well, you had to pay this sponsor at that time. And this. Look, man, it's too much red tape they got across. Just had this shit on DVDs.
See, man. That's...
And the cold part about it, Mike can't do it because he didn't own his own name at the time. Whoever was promoting him owned his name.
That's beautiful, man.
But I would love to be able to, like, yeah, Riviera do got a little pop, don't he? Say what? But I would love to be able to make that happen for boxers where they can put their fights on DVD after they retire. You know what I'm saying?
Almost like a mixtape.
Yeah, a mixtape or each day or their entire fight. And everybody they fought should get a piece of it. You know what I'm saying? That ain't too hard. Everybody that I fought in my career, and just, hey, you're going to be getting some residuals based off how many sales we get. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. I don't think they'll say no. Shit, that's free money.
Hey.
That's how I feel if I could have a Roy collection. Right. See what I'm saying? Say what? Like he just said it, if I could have a Roy collection. You ain't never lied, sir. You ain't never lied. We'll have. Do I got that shit right here? Where that shit at? Yeah, we'll have this fight right here. Oh, it ain't gonna come up. I forgot I gotta play with it. Where is it? No, I don't think it's gonna come up.
Like, I would, man. You know, sometimes I'd be wanting to go buy up these storage bins and everything like that to be like, man, let me find something like that.
Right.
Well, man, you do buying all the storage from Storage Wars and stuff like that, and you find an autographed pair of gloves from Ali.
That shit crazy, bro. And you want to know what make me mad? I had plenty of chances to buy some Ali shit before he passed away. And as soon as he passed away, that shit went skyrocket. That shit made me mad. Nothing I can tell you. I had a motherfucking Michael Jordan signed jersey from summer camp, his basketball summer camp he used to have, and I sold that motherfucker. I should never did that shit.
I had something, and I can't even pay to give it away. People don't want it.
What?
I had a T-shirt signed by Chris Benoit.
Yeah. You'll find somebody who want that. Look, man. Look, I'm about to say something. Fucked up what he did, but I don't give a fuck about his personal life. I give a fuck with it's entertainment. Because I got to say this right now. I'm going to say it on here. Let me pull the chat up so I can see if anybody got something to say. Look, we was in our own little chat on the phone, talking about verses, and the question came up with who could beat Usher. You remember that?
Mm-hmm.
Niggas, one nigga who can if people can get out their feelings.
R. Kelly.
Yep. Now tell me who gonna be R. Kelly though. You gotta jump straight to the King of Pop for that. You ain't.
Damn.
You right. So if people can get out their little feelings, yeah, you can be beat.
Jesus.
Come on, man. We talking about the entire catalog of his. Not to mention he wrote for Trey Songz, B2K, IMX. You know how many people he wrote? They albums and singles and, man, come on, bro. Yeah. Woo, this is a fight. Right. Say what? Say the only person is MJ. Who would be able to beat him, right?
But who would beat MJ?
No. Nobody. It would be a... And I hate when people want to battle Prince and him. Him and Prince is the opposite end of the spectrum. They ruled the opposite end of the spectrum. You know what I'm saying? I mean, hell, Michael Jackson didn't start cursing until they don't really care about us.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Straight up. So, I mean, that was like he was the Christian and Prince was hell. But they both ruled their kingdoms respectfully. You know? Ooh. Say what said Beyonce? Beyonce ain't... Man, who would be Beyonce? Anybody you put in front of her? Now, doing a versus hit for hit? Man, look, I'm just not a fan. I'm more of a Destiny Giles fan. But like... There's women that will kill her in a singing battle. Like Jennifer Hudson. I wish she would say she could sing better than Jennifer Hudson. I wish she would. There's so many women out here that got true vocal skills that don't need the studio. You, Christina Aguilera could blow, nigga.
Yes, she can.
She can blow. That girl got soul, bro. I saw her in person. That shit's real. You know what I'm saying? I was like, God damn, I felt that shit. That girl can sing. She'll kill Beyonce in a sing-off. Hit for hit? No. Beyonce will kill him, but singing for real, for real? Come on, bro.
Fucking Jasmine Sullivan will kill
him. Damn right. That's soul right there. That bitch crazy anyways, though. That's something crazy, man. That motherfucker bitch crazy. That bitch want to blow you up, flatten your tires, break your windows. Oh, that shit. That motherfucker been through some shit. She's our modern day Mary J. Blige. She got that pain music. You know what I'm saying? That voice that just sound good about pain music. Like Aretha Franklin. You know, them type of voices, you know, Aretha Franklin's best songs is when she's demanding something or singing about something sad type stuff. You know what I'm saying? That pain music.
Ooh, cause out, man.
Say what? Said don't let the beehive catch this. They gonna come for you. Yeah, I know they. I'm ready for it. I got my fly swatter ready.
Only thing a bee is good for is making honey. Other than that, it ain't worth it.
I promise you. Hey, Fantasia killing all them off vocals. Fantasia is the modern day Patti LaBelle, but she control it more.
Mm-hmm.
No lie. When I first heard that girl sing on American Idol, I said, oh, she can't tell me she grew up listening to Patti LaBelle. That's all it's modern true. Day Patti LaBelle.
That's true. I ain't even going to deny that. Dang.
Yeah, man. Well, but like I said, she sound good singing what she sing. She just dropped the album not too long ago.
She did?
Yeah.
Oh, damn.
Diabetes is everything, man. Especially nowadays, they're so selective of what they want to put out there for people. You know, in the golden years, which was the 90s, they let your vocals and stuff prove for themselves. You know what I'm saying? Instead of picking people out and pumping them up, and they sound like garbage.
Oh, my God. There's so many artists that sound like garbage.
Man, I ain't going to stunt. I think that nigga named 42 Doug, bro, I don't like that. What do you say? Blow his ass off. Blow his ass off. That nigga sound hilarious, bro. I'm like, what is this? Hey, these niggas squabbing. I ain't going to stunt, though. This is a good match. I like what I'm seeing. But, man, what's his name? Man, I think that's his name, 42 Doug. Thugging in my Reeboks. That nigga killed me, dog. This nigga, the way he rapped me had me dying. I swear, I literally start laughing in my car. Ooh. Riviera got him. Ooh. I mean, Fernandez got Riviera. My bad, y'all. Ooh. I did not see that coming on me. I don't think he saw it neither. That's his say what? That's him knock his head off, knock his dreads off. That nigga, that shit tickles me, man. I be laughing. Like, this nigga sound like a little gnat. Like, when he started rapping, I start thinking about, remember on the old cartoons when they had to flee? And they be like, boink, boink, boink. When they...
Yeah.
Because he sounds so little, dog. That's what I start thinking about.
I mean, the same can be said for Boosie, too.
But see, look. Boosie, you want to know something? His voice didn't just grow with him. But at least Boosie was young. A lot of people know Boosie was young, bro. When they, before gangster music, they was like, them niggas was like 13, 14 years old. You know what I'm saying? Because on gangster music, they was 16. Cause that was, well, who was the other nigga name with the unibrow?
What was that nigga's name?
Webby. Webby. They were 16. It was like 15, 16 years on gangster music. And that's when they had they was fucking with UGK. Remember they was fucking with Bun B, Trill Music.
Yeah.
Yeah, they was young, so it was understanding his little ass voice. It's like him and Lil Wayne voice just didn't grow with him. You know what I'm saying? Cause he still got a little voice. This nigga grown. Knock a leg out. That shit's so funny. Starting in my Reebok. Man, I don't know. And it's like, don't none of that shit go. Right. See, yeah, Boosie was 14 when they started. That's what I said. And they was selling dope already though. Them niggas really had money though. I remember them dumbass nigga when Bumby was trying to have a talk with them, like quit making them videos, throwing money in the air in the parking lot and shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, you drawing attention to yourself. That's when Bumby got a hold of them little niggas. Like, cause they was already getting money. That young, you know what I'm saying? He got a hold on cause he didn't want to see nothing go bad when plus they was rapping and shit. They was, and the cold part about it, to be that young, people gotta give Boosie his props. They was kind of running it. Cause when they hit 16, they had Fox a Million. They had a couple of motherfuckers and they was all on the radio. To be that young. And that's when they was trying to perpetuate that Boosie and Webby. I mean, not Webby. Boosie and Lil Wayne beef. It was like people want them niggas to go at it for some reason.
I don't know why they would.
Yeah, because that was during the time. Remember when Lil Wayne had that mixtape, Louisiana Animal?
Yeah. I remember that. Shit. Man, hey. I've never understood. Why does Wayne actually go harder on mixtapes than he ever did on albums?
Because the scheme, see, especially right now, since everything digital, they make money off them mixtapes. See, before they stole mixtapes out for free. Remember, you used to take anybody beat, bro, and rap on it, right?
Mm-hmm.
And they stole them out there. Remember the Gangsta Grills, all that stuff, right? Shoot, now that stuff on their digital, they get money for that. Yeah, every time you click on one, it's money. And if you buy it, you gotta, if you don't got a plan and you want that song, you gotta buy it.
Yeah.
But that, you ain't lying. That nigga EPs and that nigga mixtapes way harder.
Yeah. because I still play No Ceilings.
Damn right. No Ceilings 1 and 2.
No Ceilings, motherfucker. Good morning. In your mouth, boy.
Man, what EP was that he dropped? It was called, I don't know what the album was called. I forgot, man. Goddamn, with the one, I'm me, who you. Nigga, that shit was hard. I was like, that nigga was sober when he wrote this shit. Nigga, this shit was hard as or freestyling, because nigga, I was like, this nigga killing this motherfucker.
He put that in putting it on the card, but it was from something else.
Y'all niggas was, he said, I knew I should got a Grammy. You niggas was sleeping on me like a nigga in his jammies. That nigga was killing that song, man. And then that one mixtape, I can't remember what, I got it too, I can't remember. But
The Leak.
Yeah. That shit was hard, bro. That shit went hard, bro, on my mama.
Man, I'm sorry, but Wayne's mixtapes, hey.
Classics. Like the official mixtapes. Classics, bro. Classics.
And everybody take some of the songs and put them on albums.
For real. And everybody be like the dedication. Okay. Dedication stuff was nice, but go back to Squad. Go back to, like, man, he got some shit, boy. It was everything that was right for that era that he did. He grew with the era. You get what I'm saying? That was the beautiful part about a Lil Wayne. He didn't stay in his era. He grew with the times. You know what I'm saying?
See, everybody talks about dedication is fine. It's fine. Mm-hmm. But it depends on which one you listening to.
That too. And it blew his mixtape game up, because at the time DJ Drama was the hottest DJ, and everybody was wondering why they hadn't even, you know what I'm saying? Which was a gift and a curse for that man. And same thing for whatchamacallit. A lot of people don't know Jeezy had mixtapes out, bro. There go Brandon Lee.
Oh my God, Jeezy's mixtape.
Yeah, Jeezy had already had mixtapes. He had Come Shop With Me 1 and 2 was out before the Trap or Die. And that Trap or Die blew up with DJ Drama. You know what I'm saying?
Already.
And I'll be honest with you, that motherfucking goddamn me Trap or Die mixtape, my nigga, still killing all his albums to me. That shit go hard. I don't give a fuck. And half the songs ain't even full songs.
Mm-mm.
That's why he had to steal. If you notice on his first official album, he stole like 4 or 5 songs off the mixtape.
Trapping ain't dead. These niggas just dead.
Man, that shit was hard, bro. I still bump that Trap or Die mixtape. I'm hunting for that shit on LP. If I get that shit on LP, bro, oh my God, I feel like I made it.
Oh my, hey. There's a lot of people who got some dope mixtapes.
Man, it's hella people. They mixtapes killing their albums. And some do still today, like some mess up, because they'll put like 3 old ass mixtapes out before their album drop, and then the album just be pure garbage.
I think they do that on purpose. I think they do that just to fulfill the contract.
Well, they could do that shit, but the only person who got that shit in sync, let me tell you. Ooh, I'm sorry, I mean yelling at motherfucker. Oh my God, say what? Did you see that? Man, this nigga gave him a 1-2. Look like a shotgun. This nigga can't even stand up. Riviera knocked that nigga down. Knocked him out. The one with the Ali shit on. Man, he gave that nigga a 2-piece to the side of the head. Nigga, I saw it. It was like slow-mo looking at shit. Like, this shit finna connect. He finna die. He ain't getting up. He sleep, bruh.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Damn. That nigga say what? Say sheesh. That nigga still can't stand up. Call the medics. Give him some milk.
Man, get that man a Sensu bean.
God, something. I like that. See, I like that about him. He trying to go over there and make sure he's all right. They won't let him go over there. I hate that shit. He just want to make sure he's all right. Shit. You don't go in there and try to kill nobody, but shit. They get, like, he got hit with 2 slugs.
Hey,
Oh, say Wood ahead of me. He said, I was waiting on you to see it. I appreciate that, say Wood.
Hey, another cool-ass Wayne mixtape was the first Sorry for the Wait.
Oh, hell yeah. That's a boy. That's when that nigga was, hey, that's when that nigga was coming out like two mixtapes at a time. It was like one mixtape this week, the next week you have another one.
I was in Korea when Sorry for the Wait dropped. Nigga, when
yeah,
I
that's when
that
he was
shit,
gone a little bit, but hey,
that shit had the clubs jumping.
But that Carter 3 was the truth, though. I ain't gonna stunt.
Carter 3 and Father Like Son was cool.
Yeah, Father Like Son was cool. Oh my god, that left and then that right followed. My nigga was sleep. Hey, he was like dangling on his own knees. Like, you know how a heroin addict don't fall? That's how he looked. Like he wasn't gonna fall, but he was like he was dangling like dang, you know, and then he finally just fell over like fuck. Where my phone? Fuck, they gotta show it one more time because this gotta get posted, nigga. So one more time. Come on, don't do me like that. There we go. No, that's a picture. Oh fuck, I ain't gonna show it no more. Come on, show one more time. Can I rewind this shit? I can rewind this shit. Yeah, we definitely finna try to rewind that. That's bullshit.
Man.
Oh, yeah, I can rewind it. Oh, damn, that shit went all the way back to round 8. Nah, nigga, I want the whole thing. Okay, there we go. Now let's get it. I'm finna show you. Can you see me live, Polo? On YouTube? I'm gonna show it on YouTube.
Wow. Hold on, let me pull it up.
This nigga right here. Oh my god, that was. Alright, here we go. It was a jab to the face and a right hook to the side of the head. That nigga damn it died. Damn.
He almost killed that man.
Oh my god. Look, boom, a blinding jab. Bow! Right in the temple. Now they showing it. This nigga, and the way he fell was like he was dangling, like he was sitting, like he thought it was a chair or something. Straight up, you know how you pull a chair from under somebody, look like they're sitting on earth, and then they fall.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's pretty much like, dang, bro, that was crazy. Yeah, I gotta show this to y'all. This was nuts. Woo, that's some pretty shit. Hold on, why you playing though? Don't play yet. What? Damn, I hate iPhones, man. Okay. I'm going to see if I can put on camera. Let me pull me up. All right. All right, you got me live?
Yep. Jesus. Jesus. Oh no. Oh no.
Yeah. That was crazy, bro. That shit was crazy, bro. That was a good knockout. That was a good knockout.
It wasn't so much that it was a good knockout. It was just picture perfect.
Yeah, it was. Yes, it was. My favorite part, though, he had the Ali shorts on. He rose his hand how Ali did over Sonny Liston. That was tough.
Oh, my God. Hey, he's been getting a resurgence of fans lately.
Who, Riviera?
No, Sonny Liston.
Yeah, they got a whatchamacallit documentary about to come out about him.
Uh-huh.
They got a documentary on him, Dick Gregory. I got to see that. I still ain't watched that Kings. I'm probably going to watch that tomorrow for Kings.
I still haven't watched it either.
But I'm going to probably, Dick Gregory, I got to watch that.
I want to see it then. Yeah.
You got Amazon Prime?
No. Actually, I think I do because I just had to buy a new TV. Oh, yeah, my dog is gone.
Got rid of him?
Uh-huh.
Damn, dog, why you get rid of the retarded dog?
Because of that being retarded.
That little kid, we said, you retarded ass dog. I ain't heard nobody call that dog retarded. That shit was funny as hell.
Look, bro.
That shit was too funny when you know said that.
You know how some TVs, when you're not using them, they have screensavers that pop up and it, you know, things like that, right? Like a laptop almost. Well, my TV popped up with a screensaver with a field. And then, you know, it had the live ones to where you could see the grass blowing and moving and stuff like that.
Right.
This fool ran and jumped into the TV.
Bro, dog, I would love to meet that dog, bro. I love to meet that dog. Oh my god, bro! Y'all show y'all getting that dog high as a puppy, man.
No, she was a rescue. She was a rescue, but the way I look at it now, I could have just left her ass where the hell she was at. Like, she literally jumped into the TV and then looked at me like I did something wrong. She put her paws down and started growling and all that stuff at me like I did something.
You tricked
me.
Because you tricked her. That nigga was like, nigga, you tricked me, man.
So
that's hilarious, bro.
I put the TV out on the curb, and I put her ass out on the curb.
Damn, bro.
In her kennel. Somebody came by and got her in the kennel and TV.
Yo ass crazy, bro. I mean,
damn, dog. I'm done with animals. Right, I'm done. I'm done. I done held a funeral service for a hamster. I done buried a goldfish. I done had a dog try to commit suicide.
Don't bring your pets over to y'all. You know, motherfuckers at home. He ain't coming back right. He ain't gonna come back right. Hell nah. Bro, that shit is hilarious on my mama.
I had a cat scratch his face up. I don't know what the hell is going on.
Man, my brother had this dumbass cat. And we used to play the little laser pointer and run that motherfucker into the wall. Nigga, run clean to the goddamn wall. Like, this motherfucker crazy. That took the cake, man. No. Hey, that should be funny, though. I be looking up dogs dreaming. Nigga, that should be hilarious, bro. I be dying. I like this nigga think he running, laying down, running and shit. Then they jump up and they run into the wall. You ever looked at that shit?
No.
This type dogs dreaming.
You overplaying what I said. This cat was literally scratching at its face.
What? That nigga ate too much cat litter. That nigga was eating his own cat litter, bro. He was tripping.
He literally scratched one of his eyes to where, you know how they have the opaque thing to where it's a white eye or whatever? Uh-huh. He literally scratched himself into that condition.
Oh, he was tripping, bro.
I took his ass to the shelter. Yeah. I was like, y'all motherfuckers gave me a defective cat. Something wrong with this damn thing. Either y'all could put him down or I'ma put him down.
You gotta get him back. Take him back. Take him back. He gotta go. For real.
Man, animals are crazy. Something wrong with these animals. I seen a mama squirrel kick three of her little squirrellings out of their little nest.
Hell yeah, they'll do that shit because they gotta learn.
They was the little pink dot things, just newborns or whatever.
I wonder if somebody touch them or something.
I don't know.
You know, animal, you know, stuff like that.
Them little motherfuckers flying out the tree.
That's fucked up.
In the ground.
That's fucked up. Hey, like, you all know something that happened to me yesterday that I ain't never seen? A fucking wasp flew in through one side of my window while I was driving. And as I was rolling him up, he knocked himself out. He ran smack into the window. and knocked yourself out. And I just dumped his little ass out the window, nigga. Like, I was for real. Like, I'm driving. This window was down. But I was already rolling my driver's side window up. He came through here. I guess he thought he was trying to do a shortcut or some shit. I thought he was going to cut past my face, like, yeah, and go out the other window. That motherfucking window was like, yeah, boop. And he just feel like, doop. He was on the edge of the window and my car door. I rolled that motherfucker back down and thumped his ass out, like, ding. I had never seen shit like that, boy. I was like, God, this nigga straight knocked out.
Well, my wife come here. I'll let her tell you about the double homicide she did. She was driving. And I'm sitting here looking at her driving down the street, coming to the house. All of a sudden, a bird is chasing a squirrel.
What?
A bird is chasing a squirrel. They both run in front of her car. She hit both of them. One went underneath, the other one went over top.
Let me tell y'all something. Animals ain't safe. Don't bring your animals over that way. They ain't going to make it. They are not going to make it, Brett. Oh my God! What's y'all predictions on the Colbert fight? I'm hoping Chris Colbert win. That's what I'm going with.
Colbert's gonna win,
but it's gonna be a fight because usually Nyambayar he brings it. You know what I'm saying? He brings it. She would have had a one way ticket back to the pound. Right? He talking about the dog. Hey, that's still hilarious, bro. This nigga be called that dog. Y'all went over here. I don't know if you was on here. I don't even think we was live when he said that shit. Nigga said retarded ass dog. I was like, God damn. He straight called a dog retarded. I had never heard nobody call that dog retarded before.
Like, no. Like, seriously, Slick. This dog would be in her kennel trying to dig the corner of the kennel.
Damn, but for trying to get free, man.
That's what the door opened.
Oh, hell no. that dog was special. That was one of Guy's special dogs. Yeah, man. I ain't gonna let you piss me off too. What the fuck you doing, man? Damn. The door open.
That's why I used to put my stuff on pause. You always hear like a scratching noise, like a trick, 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 trick. That was her digging in the kennel.
Hell no. J Beats and Waves, what's happening? What's going on, man? Waiting on this Chris Colbert fight. Woo! That was clean, boy. I'm about to rewind that. That was nice. I'm going to show you this little Nyambayar highlight they just showed real quick. Let me get my phone out. I think I went back too far. Nah, I didn't. Yeah, I did. Come on. Boy, it's like, shoot. This whole time, you know, I can do that shit, rewind on this mug, paying for this stuff, because I don't watch it enough unless it's just boxings. Man, where is that? Okay.
Say what's the mental illness is real.
Man, straight up. And that shit was crazy.
Say what, you have to have heard and seen some of the things this dog has done.
Here we go. Hold on. Let me record this. Oh man, show it. Oh, here you go. Beat the shit out that nigga. I'm just trying. I want y'all to see this. This is off the chain. This right here. This step back he did. He gonna turn out. That shit was fire right there. Here, I'm about to play this for y'all. Y'all gotta see this.
Jesus.
This is crazy. Let me pull myself up. So I got the chat up. Okay. Ain't no sound. Oh, yeah, ain't no sound. But look at this. He better go ham on this nigga. This is the fight we finna see. You saw that? And then, right here, look at the step back. Step back, bitch. That was like the Jordan turnaround. You know what I'm talking about?
God.
That's what we finna look at. Some shit like that.
Could this be one of those underrated fight of the year candidates? Yep.
With a cat like that, most definitely. Oh boy, Leo Santa Cruz. I was just about to say, oh boy, until his name popped up on the screen. Swear to God. I always forget his name, man. Sorry, Leo, man. I'm going to interview you one day, man. I'm probably going to be like, what's your name again? The whole interview.
Don't, man, don't do that, man, like that.
I be forgetting, it be legit, bro. I do not, it's not like it's, he's the only one I do that to. I be like, and what's that dude name that got knocked out? Like, like damn. Look at that, Frank Shamrock there. Frank Shamrock, Zab Zuda there, Leo Santa Cruz there. Damn, Frank look old, boy.
They look bad now.
AJ Mackey there. Oh yeah, that same dude had the little shit on. I like that watch you got on though.
I need to get me a new watch.
Do me a favor, G. Hold it down real quick. I gotta go lay. I want to lay my little baby down.
All right. So. As we're talking about mental illness in the animal community, have any of you guys got your pet spayed or neutered recently?
What the hell? I said take over, goddammit.
Please get your pets checked. And have you dewormed them recently? Fleas and ticks are real, people. Fleas and ticks are real. Oh, you don't want to be in a situation where you're laying in bed and you get the itchy, itchy, tickle, tickles, and it turns out it's fleas. You don't want that. Not a good feeling. Okay. With all that out the way, Colbert is going to win this fight. I mean, I ain't even no way around it. Colbert's going to win this fight. He's going to stomp this dude. I'm sorry, but he is. And after this, yes, it's an interim title shot, but I believe that he deserves the whole thing. That knockout was beautiful, E-Dub. That knockout was gorgeous. We'll tell you what else was gorgeous. At Walmart, Samsung TVs are on sale for $398, 43-inch. Stop in your local Walmart. Get one. They're smart TVs. What y'all want to talk about? What y'all got going on? Oh. Have y'all noticed how 4K TVs make boxing look even more brutal, or UFC? It makes them look worse than what it actually is. A reminder. If you are going to be in the Vegas area from August 19th through the 22nd, we will be holding a live judges table on the 22nd. On the 21st, we will be hosting a roundtable pool party at the Virgin Mobile Hotel before the fight. Come on out, support your boys, and let's get this cracking. Not a damn thing, my son. Said I ain't popping fireworks. Man, I'm not popping fireworks anyway. I don't believe in just putting my money in a pile and setting it on fire. I'll go watch other people do it. Man, I've grilled so much, I don't even like the taste of it no more. I done grilled everything. I done grilled pork chops, shrimp, lamb, ribs. Heck, I didn't even put some dang ham hocks on the grill. I done grilled everything. I done put macaroni on the grill. I'm tired of grilling. So today, I decided to fix some good old-fashioned beans and cornbread and cabbage. Oh, God. Oh, this boxing game is wonderful. If anybody knows about Colbert, do you see him going up in weight?
All right, I'm back.
Man, say what? I'm in Kansas City, and I'm tired of grilling. Kansas City is like one of the homes for grilling, and I'm tired of grilling.
Midwest. Y'all got to come out this way. We grill year-round.
We literally.
In the snow, all that.
All you can do is just get a few sticks, pop a tarp out over your patio, and just light the grill up.
I promise you, if you ain't got it, it's still going there. I don't give a shit.
Nigga, I done went as far as to put my grill in the garage and just open up the doors.
Facts, E-Dub, what's going on?
With the beans and cornbread with some cabbage, that's all you need sometimes.
Man, tomorrow I heard you say something about shrimp. I'm making homemade shrimp Alfredo tomorrow. That's something I want. Same, I'm in Texas. See, it stay hot out there, though. When we be in the cold, I don't care. I wake up, but I don't care. Man, I don't care if it's snow. It could be 4 inches, 5 inches snow. If I wake morning, I want some barbecue chicken. I'll cook me some barbecue chicken. And then, like in California, too, like hot places, it's like certain cuts of meat ain't around. That's one thing about here, like, when I was living in California, I was looking for a pork shoulder. Them niggas like pork shoulder. We ain't got no pork shoulder. Like, what's that? I'm like, what? You know what I'm saying? They don't be knowing.
See, man, I be wanting a good pork butt.
They ain't had it neither.
Man, just a good pork butt. Put it on that indirect heating, low and slow.
Low and slow. There you go.
All you need for that is to cover it in a little bit of Dijon mustard and then put that salt and pepper on there.
That's all day work. And that's another thing, like, I did out there. They was like, you putting mustard on the meat? I'm like, yeah, bro. The hell? What y'all be doing? They was like, what you mixing in that water bottle? There's a lot of stuff I know that a lot of people don't do everywhere.
Apple cider vinegar along with a little bit of seasoned salt, garlic powder, onion powder.
I promise you.
Just spray it on there to keep it moist.
Nice and flavorful.
I'd rather do a spray bottle than to do the injections.
Yeah.
Because if I do the injections, you're going to mess up the sinew in the meat. Why not have it break down naturally instead of have it break down with the vinegar?
Right.
See, well, we can get y'all right grilling from here in the Midwest.
I promise you, we'll be on it. Mr. Z, what's happening?
What's up, y'all? I just jumped on and said, man, live show. I've been listening, even though I'm at my little boy party. But I just want to tell everybody in the chat, what's up? You got Polo J. You got Slick 50, the greatest boxing commentary on the tube. Coming up in 3 weeks, we're going to be back live again. Deontay Wilder and Tyson Fury. Right after that, they're going to be live in Las Vegas. Man, it's just too much going on to talk about it right now.
Yeah. That's why I was telling him, man. I kept forgetting to keep mentioning. You hear me? It's going to be so much going on, man. It's going to be nuts. We're going to be live. We're going to have a... Go ahead.
And not to interrupt Slick, because like I said, I can't stay on long. If y'all love the commentary, y'all love talking to these dudes, y'all can see these two men live and in person, and you can have the opportunity to debate them live at the judges' table, live in Las Vegas, Sunday, August 22nd, 11 a.m. Pacific Standard Time.
Yes.
Also, you know it's about the series. You know you love the GMT. You know these guys are so, like, into what they do, but they like to have fun, too. And they're going to let y'all know about that Saturday, August 21st. We're going to be letting y'all know about that real soon as well.
Yeah. That's gonna be a wild
one. Yes.
Yes. Yes, you don't want to miss it. So it's going to be a whole GMT in the Red Corner weekend in Las Vegas. So if you're planning to come out, there's going to be plenty of times where you can meet these guys. And then, like I say, we all going to put the icing on the cake that Sunday because we're going to react live to Errol Spence versus Manny Pacquiao. And y'all can give them your feedback live. And y'all get to be about it.
And it's going to start on Thursday. Thursday is media day. Friday is the weigh-in. Saturday is the fight. It may be something going on before the fight. We go announce that.
Yeah.
And then you got a Sunday live podcast in studio. All right? In studio. And you can come up and be part of that experience. You can be on there live with us in the studio, hashing it out with us of what y'all thought about the fight. Or if you just want to come through and say what's up, come through and say what's up.
Now, one thing I can say, the King of Strong Style and the Ice King will be turning up.
Right.
We will be turning up. And the turn up will not be televised.
Facts, because quiet as kill. And that your birthday weekend?
That's my birthday. The 21st is my birthday.
Yes, sir.
Brother.
Yes, sir. Okay, Chris.
So.
I told you, look at this, look at this. Oh, my God. This, I told y'all this was going to be a fight. This was going to be a fight. This may make fight of the year, bro. They already squabbling.
Mm-hmm.
Anybody
y'all
coming?
Before all that good stuff, y'all, I'm about to get off here. I just wanted to say what's up to the chat. But before all that, like I said, we a little bit in 2.5 weeks away.
Yeah.
Big WBC heavyweight bout live in Las Vegas from T-Mobile Arena. We have Tyson Fury defending his heavyweight championship against Deontay Wilder. And guess who bringing you that fight week live? Right here.
Yes, like nobody else. Like he never like. Y'all know how we do. Behind the scenes, mode live interviews and all of that. Woo, they banging.
Yes. Yes, yes, yes. Things are about to start heating up, y'all.
Big time. Well, see, when I did my live, I told y'all be so much stuff going on the boxing side. That's why I had a chance to do a for real podcast over there on Slick 50 TV. So much behind the scenes stuff working. You know, man, we working. That's all y'all need to know. We working. We trying to, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
But y'all make y'all plans, man. Y'all coming out to Vegas, I'm here to tell you, hotels filling up, flights filling up. They're going to be SummerSlam out there the exact same day, right across the way at Allegiant Stadium. And also Ice Cube's Big 3 Championship is also going to be going down.
That's
so the city
huge.
Is going to be lit, packed, everything in between, y'all.
Right.
So if you're making your plans, come on out, man.
And who knows, you might see us there too.
For real. I just take it. I mean, shit. That's interviews all the way around. Wrestling. Cube and them gonna be out there. That's gonna be popping. That's a popping weekend, bro. We gonna be some busy people.
It's not gonna be all play, y'all. Don't think that we're going out there for play. This is for work.
Yeah, this is what we do. This is what this we love to do. It ain't really work when you love it, but I hear you. I hear you 100%. This is for the brand, you know what I'm saying? And for y'all, man, shit, that's what we're really about. To bring the experience to y'all for those who can't get it, who can't experience that experience, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. Oh,
man. And like I say, the man just said it. It's that man's birthday Saturday.
Facts.
Is he gonna get his birthday gift? Is Errol gonna take Pacquiao? Or is Pacquiao gonna take Errol? We shall see.
Right.
That's what's going to happen.
That was a crazy first round.
That's what's going to happen. I'm telling you what's going to happen. Earl is not going to win.
He said Earl is not going to win.
And then we're going to have a championship scramble. And then, oh, my God, we're going to finally get the fights that we want.
Ain't going to have no choice.
Ain't gonna be no choice. Ain't no fun when the rabbit got the gun, goddamn.
I'm telling
you. Uh-oh. So, yes, y'all, it is going to be a hell of a weekend. Like I said, I'm signing off. I just want to come in, holler at these dudes, holler at everybody in the chat, let y'all know, man, get y'all tickets, get y'all hotel room. And you ain't even coming to the fight. Just come hang out. We're going to be all over. These dudes going to be vlogging. They're going to be everywhere. You even might catch them at an after party somewhere.
Promise you.
Partying with Pacquiao. You never knew.
Promise you.
Hold on now.
Trust me. Just know it's going to be a lot of vlogs, a lot of interviews, a lot of everything. That just, weekend just is going to be packed. Thing. Everything.
Just remember one thing. I have a bedtime.
Oh, stop it. Ain't no bedtime there, bro.
Please stop.
We ain't going to bed from the time we get there and you get home and plant back on that plane to go home.
Well, I guess I need some speed.
Yeah, you need some. You need some. Keep your ass with no dose, nigga.
Don't worry. Down at the lobby of the hotel, there's IV station where you can take a 60-minute IV and recharge.
For real? Man, hell no.
Yes. There are IV stations.
That's what Mayweather was before the Pacquiao fight. When they said he had an IV.
They in different lobbies of the hotel. That's just like if you going so hard, you need an IV to re-energize. They say you feel better. I never did it before.
That's crazy.
They say if you need to re-energize and get back right, hey man, that's what you gotta do. You gotta do it.
That's what you gotta do.
So wow. Polo. Ain't no sleep.
I'm definitely putting that on the vlog. I'm putting that on the vlog. Hey, this fight is ridiculous, bro.
Oh, God.
Chris Colbert, speed has went up. I'm talking about he fast.
Oh, my God. Y'all going to see me half dead in Vegas, them holding me up with an IV in my arm. Talking about you can do it.
Bro, you can do it.
I'm no. Next thing you know,
Polo, I have faith in you, man. What they say, what the old Army commercials used to say, we do more before 9 a.m. than some people do all day.
Right.
I know you got it, man.
Ooh. Back when I was a young man.
Here you go, this old talk. Nah, we gonna be I'm out pushing. There kicking it. Kicking man, it I'm and pushing. Working at the same time, man.
Man, I'm pushing 34, man. You don't know what that's like.
Shit.
Oh, my God.
What did he say that? Boy.
Oh, my God.
I ain't going to get to talking.
I'm not even about to tell my
ass. I promise you.
We ain't
going
to even talk about. You're going to be fine, man.
Man, y'all young men don't even know about what I'm going through. Y'all ain't even got backs yet. Y'all still got gristle.
Shit. That nigga said, still got grist. What is this dude, Chris Cole, trying to land this overhand right like it ain't shit?
If he lands it, it's over.
Hey, but Nyambayar, he ain't playing. He ain't playing easy. But, say what?
Jesus. That's an old back of
mine. Oh, and another thing, too, y'all, before I go. I know I keep saying I'm about to go, but I am. Stay tuned. There's all kind of boxing news going to be coming through, bro. All kind of boxing news. So y'all stay tuned to GMT Boxing in the Red Corner Boxing with Polo J. You will get the uncut real news here.
Facts.
Yeah, there's a lot of fake news going around. Ain't that right, Donald Trump?
Mm-hmm.
You will get the real news here. Because if y'all been tuning in the Red Corner with Polo J, he let y'all know about a big fight going down on Christmas night.
Yeah, that's going to be huge.
Possibly.
They going to make it happen.
Possibly.
If it ain't Christmas, it's going to be in December.
I just put these two guys up on a little video that I came across. I wanted to catch it before they did the judges table, but I was late. About how Floyd went up to the corner round the seventh round and told the man he was losing on all the corners.
Mm-hmm.
There's YouTube and video proof of that.
Yep.
And he said, "Oh, I'm keeping it 100 with you. Why would I lie
to you? Why would I lie to you?"
My daddy told me a long time ago, when a man tell you, "Why would I lie? I wouldn't lie to you." He lying.
He lying. Right. Right. He said, "That's what you want me to do, keep it 100 with you, right?" For sure, what he said. And we were just talking about the earlier, like, it should be a rule where he shouldn't be able to do that shit. If your trainer don't tell you nothing, you shouldn't be able to do it. But ain't no rule in place for it. Because, like, say he a promoter. He can walk all the way around that ring if he want.
He the promoter. That's his ring. That's his venue for the night. He can do anything he wanted.
Yep. Somebody got to get knocked out in this fight the way these cats fighting.
Well, I'm going to let y'all guys finish. Like I said, everybody in the chat, what's up, man? Keep it locked in. Polo and Slick is going to finish it off, man. Y'all be cool, man. I'll be hollering at y'all in about 2.5 weeks, man.
All right, Mr. Z.
I'm out.
That's the man right y'all there, man. Colbert better stay behind that jab. Not, it's going to be night. Right, that's what I'm saying. But he got that speed, but it ain't connecting. And Nyambayar, he's utilizing the jab to try to time all of that. He keep putting the stick out there to neutralize it and everything.
This is it. I heard you on one of five videos here.
Say what? Yeah, Mr. Z be working, bro. You know what I'm saying? We a team, man. Shout out to Mr. Z.
Mm-hmm. Shout out Mr. Z, man.
Yes, sir.
Oh, God. Colbert put that man out yet?
No, not yet, but I'm saying they banging. This could quickly turn to one of fight of the years. This is off the charts, bro.
Oh, shoot. Let's hope that it does. We can only hope.
Because this is the type of fight that Colbert need. He put Nyambayar down because this is Nyambayar. I showed y'all, he come to fight. He comes to fight. And I'm liking this. I'm liking what I see. He just missed it. But it's like Chris Colbert is hoping on this one punch, this overhand right in that right hook. It's like he want to land that so bad, but he can't do that. He gonna have to poise himself. He's really gonna have to do that. He's not gonna be able to do that. Nyambayar takes so much advantage of that, of staying away from his right hand. It's ridiculous. He's landing his own. Nyambayar is getting in it. And it's like what said. If he keep doing that, he's gonna end up going night night.
Yes, he is.
He gonna end up going night night. He can't keep doing that. See what I'm saying? And then soon as he touched him one time in the face, Chris Colbert folded up. You know what I'm saying? And it'd be an onslaught. He just get the welling. Whether it land or not, he coming forward. And he only been able to make Nyambayar go back like one time. But for the most part, Nyambayar keep coming forward. He landing the more meaningful shots. But I'm telling you, they banging.
That should mean, fights like that, I don't believe they deserve to go to the decision.
No, give them an extra round.
Give them an extra round. Give it to them. Let them do it. And I'm pretty sure they will be willing to.
I don't like the reaching that Colbert is doing, though. With his jab, he's overreaching. Meaning he's not taking that step jab. He just planting his feet and reaching down. He got a head, but clash of heads. Ain't nobody bleeding, I hope. Is he bleeding? Hope he ain't bleeding. That'd be unfortunate. Okay. They good, y'all. Both of these guys got some speed on them, bro. Colbert getting ahead of himself. Yeah, he needs to poise himself because the dude, you see dude just trying to land. It's not really a plan or rhyme or reason to what Nyambayar is doing at all. You know what I'm saying? He just want to fight. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So he could take advantage of that. You know what I mean? Time him, man. he's playing to his what they say, he's playing to his fiddle. That's what he's doing. Yeah.
Dancing to his drum.
There you go. You want to slow down. You could make something out of that. Ooh, there you go. Exactly. Just like that. Throw some feints out there. He finally landed that right hand. Even though Nyambayar kind of I don't know, I always miss his name, Nyambayar or something like that. Nyambayar. That's what I'm gonna keep calling him, Babar or something. But Nyambayar. I'm trying to say his name right. But anyway. He slipped that right hand a little bit, but it finally touched his face. And it came from a feint first. Like I said, he just needs to slow down, man. He's looking for that flicking jab.
He'll find it. I got faith in him.
Yeah, I want him to win too. I just knew this wasn't gonna be no easy. You know what I'm saying? You didn't get it. You didn't pick a cat that was just gonna come by. This dude fight. He coming forward. Like on IP Man when they fight for them bags of rice. That's how he coming forward, like for real. And that wasn't that. I know that sounded kind of fucked up, but it was actually in a movie.
No, I've seen it.
It was actually in a movie. It was in a movie. And if you saw how them cats was fighting, you would understand what I'm talking about.
See, there's a difference between fighting just to fight and fighting for survival.
Yeah, like this. How like he hungry? Like nigga, no. You know what I'm saying? You ain't finna beat me. Chris Colbert keep Lil B Hop is messing me up. He is not sitting. He ain't sat down that one round. He's standing up in the corner like he's trying to showboat or something. But or maybe it would just work for him. I don't even want to say that. It might actually work for him.
Hopefully.
See right there, he gave it up. That faint. Clash of heads. He gave it up with that faint. Told on himself. If you gonna faint, you better come with something behind it.
Mm-hmm.
Whether it's another faint or a punch, but you can't faint and not do. You know what I'm saying?
That was a problem that I had with Barrios.
Mm-hmm. And not putting that damn hand back up. That shit was making me mad that night. Remember we was talking, like I was like, he keep letting that hand down, man. Keep on putting that hand down.
See, that fight is a lesson to every fight on from now. Keep your damn hands up.
Yeah, because if he would have kept his hand up, he wouldn't have got knocked down. He wouldn't have got knocked down. Man, the ref have to keep on coming in. He's looking at, I don't know what he's saying to him because I got the sound up, but I'm getting tired of the ref breaking these guys up and talk to him.
It's all right.
Man, we in round five already.
It's a good fight there. If you can't even tell what round it is and they just banging, that's a good fight. We know exactly what round it is. And there's not a lot of action. Those are the worst fights.
I don't even know how to score this shit.
Unless they're very tactical fighters. If they're very tactical fighters, then you appreciate that. But right. If they're not, and they're just not throwing, I don't like that.
That was a nice right hook to the body by Nyambayar.
Oh, man.
I think it's Nyambayar.
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 Mm-hmm.
There you go.
You gotta get out there to Asia, man.
Huh?
You gotta get out there to Asia, man.
I wanna go. That's on my bucket list. Ooh, there we go. There we go, Colbert. Nice two piece. He gave me right and left. Well, it was a left and then right. I'm sorry.
Oh my god.
I'll give Colbert 3-2. Ooh. Okay, okay. Colbert got a nice chin because Nyambayar, hey. Landed a nice overhand right. A nice overhand right. He showed he could take a punch. It made him frown up too. Like, this dude just stole on me.
Like, did you just hit me?
Right, for real. That's the face he looked. Yeah, it's close. I know it's close, say well, and everything. I just didn't know I scored because I'm talking about one get off, the other one get off. Then, like, they both go at it. Don't nobody land nothing, then they end up hugging. You know what I'm saying? But, I mean, it's constant action. Ain't nobody scared of each other at all. That's why I like. If you in the ring, what's the use of running? Let's go. You know what I'm saying? But for the most part, like I say, Nyambayar, he needs to learn how to be more strategic. You know what I'm saying? He not just wilding out. Yeah, he not just wilding out, but he need to put some more meaning behind why he throwing them punches. Colbert, like that right there, when he they just had another clash of his, but he came with a jab, feint, and he was going to throw an overhand right. But see, the thing is, Nyambayar know that's what he wants to throw. He can't keep throwing that overhand right. He going to have to come with something else. You know what I'm saying?
For see, if you thinking overhand, that's when I throw uppercut.
You know, see what got him caught up? Because old boy he's a little bit shorter. So when he got ready to throw the overhand, he threw his overhand right. He was already up under him, so it landed. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah. The way you're describing it, I can picture it.
This is a dope fight. I ain't gonna stunt. It was the fight before this was a dope fight too. Riviera, that was a clean fight. That was a nice fight. Dude dropped Riviera, then Riviera got up down there and killed the old boy.
Oh no.
I mean, that jab Colbert throwing saving him. Yeah, that's what he got. Everything need to come behind that, but he can't throw that one jab, bounce back, and then want to go to the gut and all that. You know what I'm saying? He can't keep doing that. Something needs to come from behind it, because that's why Nyambayar is really, and he wants to throw a 1-2 overhand. And Nyambayar pretty much got that time. That's why it's not landed. Ooh, now that was nice. He caught Nyambayar with an uppercut finally. Something different in the arsenal. Another uppercut. There we go. There go another uppercut. That's three in a row. So he realized that he caught him with it. But it came behind a feint, though. And then he went right back to a right hook. Anything he throwing upper, Nyambayar, see it. He needs to start from the ground up.
So,
body hit, okay, body
so
hit.
Who threw the uppercut?
Colbert.
So he did what I said he needed to do instead of the overhand.
Yeah, he caught him. He threw a jab and threw an uppercut.
And it connected.
But every time Colbert started at the top, he's looking for it. So he needs to start down low. He's not looking for that. So he needs to be working on the body, then come upstairs. You get what I'm saying? He been having more. Anytime he throw a jab right hand, dude just back up or move to the left. You know what I'm saying? I mean, move to the right and get away from it.
He could feint the overhand and go in with a mean ass straight.
That he needs to leave the overhand alone, period. This dude been throwing the overhand since round one, and I've only seen him land it twice. It's like they trained for that. Like, nigga, stay away from that. You get what I'm saying? He just threw it again, threw the overhand again. Guess what? It didn't do nothing but land in air. That's it. It don't even touch, dude. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
See, he just threw it again. It don't touch him. He need to go to the body and come on up. That's how he landed the uppercut. He threw a blinding jab and came with the uppercut, and the uppercut frame came from under, so he's not looking down. You get what I'm saying? He's
steadily up top.
Yeah, he looking at his shoulders. That's how he could telegraph the punch. You see what I'm saying? So if you concentrating on my shoulders moving first, then you ain't seeing nothing gonna come from the bottom. You see what I'm saying?
Yep. I know exactly what you're saying.
But he wants to hit him with this overhand right, man. Like, he wants to land it so bad. Like, leave that punch alone.
Switch.
He done threw this punch at least 30 times.
You don't have to throw the overhand right. You don't have to. Switch it up.
He gonna mess around and give this fight away. doing that.
He just
that.
Switch it up and set up an overhand left.
I don't think he got that, though. I don't think he got that. I think his sign is awesome. He's not the best switch hitter like that.
All I'm saying is if he sets it up right, he could land it. He doesn't have to just rely on that overhand right.
Nah, man. Because, man, look, and they pointed out now, double jab and overhand right. I'm pretty sure they're saying what I'm saying right now. And they showing it. And that's the one time he landed it. Jab, jab, overhand right.
See, man, you know what? If anybody in the chat likes to really box, you know what we could do? Set up some kind of charity event, and me and Slick will be in your corner.
Yeah, we'll be in the corner. I want to get in the ring, too. Get my fat ass knocked up. It'll be fun, though. It'll be fun, though. Shit. I'll get knocked off for charity. I'll get knocked off for charity. Just have a big cup of milk for him. Yeah, that left strictly jabbing. Exactly. That's all you're using that left for is your jab, jab, jab. All his power comes from the right side. He's not used to using that left for anything else. Exactly. Give me some milk, man. I mean, he's not even jabbing to his gut. He's not mixing it up. And anybody always ready to jump on top of that jab. Every time he throws a jab, he jumps on top of it. He throws something over the top of his jab. And as you see, okay, he's going to his right to stay away from his right. He know that everything he want to do is that. You know what I'm saying? Is it land that right hand?
Okay, tell me if you agree with this, because the way that you're describing the fight, I can see it. I can see it in my head right now.
Uh-huh.
So if I was Colbert, I would throw a jab to a double jab. I throw a jab to the gut and to the solar plex,
bro,
and then step out. And keep doing that just for a little while to throw his mind off, and then I would sidestep him and attack the body from there to get him to think about those body shots. As I'm doing that, he's going to be starting to throw his guard down, anticipating the body shot, and that's when I attack with a straight right.
Yeah, I can see that, but I'm finna. If your name pop up, shit, there we go. All right. Let's see if I can turn this around when you answer it. I just thought about something. I hear it on your side.
Let's see.
Boom, I'm going to flip this. I just thought about this. Oh, man. Damn. Okay, I just cut it down.
Hold on, I got to mute. Do I got to mute? No.
There we go. Yeah, through the phone, I can hear you. It's good. It's good. Yeah, I'm telling you, he doing the same thing. It's like he doing the same thing. He said, "Well, I think Colbert frustrated. He can't get the KO right, but he been trying to get that KO since the first round. I don't think he need the KO, man." If he wants to, he got to know how to set it up. You can't do the same thing repeatedly to get a KO. Jab, jab, overhand, right. You got to mix that shit up. Right. You should have went to Google Duo on your phone and then turn down the volume on the phone, and that way you still talk to the computer. on computer be on StreamYard. Like right now, see now he's driving. He's trying to do a sucker move. He's dropping his hands, hoping to bait him in. But I don't know. There we go.
All
right. Restart that.
All right.
Yeah, there we go.
See that now. Oh, hell, that looks better.
Yeah.
How do they have that judge or that scored?
I have no idea. Look, same jab. But then he gonna come watch. He wants to knock that, go to overhand. You saw that? He been trying to do that all night. This little dude not going nowhere. You at 8 or 12. I don't know what the scorecard's looking like. But I agree with what Say What. Say he said, I think Colbert frustrated he can't get the KO. Yeah, and I think that was his whole thing. Thought he was finna come get him out because he looks physically smaller than Colbert. But this, he come to bang, man. He not scared. He's battle tested. You know what I'm saying?
The hook is there.
It's a lot more there. He's just not utilizing it. And there it goes. Now that's the first time I seen him throw a left hook. There go the double jab and overhand right again. There go the jab. Mm-hmm.
You have your range. Why are you trying to find your range now?
There you go. That's the first time I seen that. Second time you threw a left hook.
You see, we need to be on somebody's corner slick.
But the both times they landed.
Mm-hmm. Now finish with the right hook. He can finish him with the right hook. I know he can. He just needs to disguise it as the overhand.
Yeah, he got to line that mug up. That's what I'm saying. He got to line that mug up.
Because I know he can finish it with it.
Yeah, that's a fact.
The way it's been described and the way I've seen it now, it's an exciting fight. It's just... Colbert has the advantage. He's just not using his advantage.
Right.
That hook. The hook that I said was there is...
Is that better?
Okay. Are you holding it? You don't have to hold it.
No, I was up because it wasn't level. Now I ain't.
Oh. Okay. Thank goodness he stopped going for the overhand.
Right. Well, we don't know yet. This is how he's been starting pretty much every round with the jab, jab. You know, see, they go to overhand. You saw it?
Yeah.
It's like, sometimes it looked like a hook, but the way he bring it back, it look like an overhand. You know what I'm saying? But he needs to feint and get them lefts in there because that left, them lefts is landing. Them left hooks.
The lefts are landing. He can use the... Matter of fact, the white boy is opening up. He can throw a uppercut to the body and finish it if he hits it hard enough.
Mm-hmm.
Because his hands are fast enough. Damn.
Yeah, the way he jumped in there and landed them two little left hooks. He got lucky, boy. He wasn't on the button. He'd have fell.
I'm sorry. My boy looked like a lit Black and Mild.
Stupid as fuck. The dude said a lit Black and Mild, bro. Oh, my God. I knew I was waiting on somebody to say something about that nigga hair. I wasn't going to say nothing. 69-64, I think that's what they had. It scored. Okay. For who, though? Who had 69? Oh, it's Colbert. Okay. 79-73, Colbert. All right. He still looked one-dimensional. But this is, he needs a better performance than this because he still looked one-dimensional. And I done seen him not be one-dimensional, so I know he could do more than this. I know. Look at this. See how anybody just stole all that back? Anybody all want to knock him out too, I see. Because that's the only reason he let him back out that corner.
It'll be messed up if this fight ends in a double knockout.
That's what I'm saying, man. Them black gloves always look smaller than color gloves. I swear they do. There you go.
There you go.
Okay.
Yeah. There you go. I don't know. I'm on a mesh network, man. That's what they told me. Sometimes you got to refresh yourself. I don't pay for my internet. It's free and rent. Like everybody in the apartments got it. And they was telling me, I was like, my stuff be dropping. And they was like, sometimes during them times, it has to refresh. Like, yeah, I'm about to start paying for my own in a minute. All right, here we go. How y'all got, who y'all got winning this fight? By y'all. Sorry for that disconnection, by the way, too. Who do y'all have winning this fight?
Colbert is winning. He's winning.
There you go. What is he run? See anybody? See how anybody y'all came in putting the pressure on? There we go. There we go. Mix that. There you go. Mix it up. Whatever you told him, I don't know what he said to him. That's what I'm talking about. Mix it up. I'm telling you. There you go. But you gotta make it, you gotta land though, bro. A982. Nigga say he's like a lit backwood. This nigga crazy.
Yeah, man, come on, man.
Come on, man. You gonna leave it up to the judges?
Sometimes that could be a bad thing.
Yeah, I'm right. It's like these little soft touches. The combos I see him throw, I like. But they like little soft touches of throws. You know what I'm saying? And they don't even reach. There we go.
I think Nyambayar has a little bit of power that Colbert doesn't want to really admit to.
You think he's respecting it a little bit, huh?
Yeah. Because I think if Nyambayar catches him with a good flush one to the face, it could finish it.
You said you won't be surprised they call it a draw? Huh. I'm on my way to Sacramento for the fourth. Listening to y'all on the ear pies. Okay, right on, Chappelle. Appreciate you. But like that, right there, like, why is you staying there? Not anybody else going to work?
Anybody let him out?
Yeah, why would you let him out? I don't know why you let him out. That one. Again, he tried to land that overhand. He wanted to get him out of there. That's his bunny punch. He wants to get him out of there.
He's turning into a one-trick pony.
Yeah, now I have never seen a fight like exactly like this.
If I was his corner, I'd be extremely disappointed.
There you go, jump on him. I don't know, I expect to see something different after this. I expect to see something different after this. This right when they come back out, because these are money rounds right here. These are money rounds right here.
I think you're gonna see more from Nyambayar than you are gonna see from Colbert. I wouldn't be surprised. If
somebody need to walk up to Colbert and tell him he losing. That's what somebody need to do. Toxic Piggy. Oh snap! Hold on, real quick. Oh, he left. Why you leave, Toxic Piggy? You was on some sneaky stuff, dog. That nigga was on some sneaky.
Toxic Piggy.
That's what he said. That's what his name said. Trying to jump in.
Probably a troll.
I don't know. We just seen some other weird names. Boy, where Bon Kweekwee at? And Babu the Freak.
I don't know, man. I like those guys. I think they just show up for the bigger fights. That's okay.
Yeah, we didn't see some crazy names. Toxic Piggy and all that.
Come on. Now I want Nyambayar to win.
He's stupid.
How do you throw that half-ass uppercut?
Somebody must told him he went in, because now he's dancing around the ring like he's just trying to skate through these last two rounds. And he, I don't like that. You got to win convincingly, bro. He need to win convincingly instead of just dancing around, pot-shotting now.
I don't think this does anything for his stock. Even
Either now. Because all they're going to say that he might have been up on the scorecards, but he was struggling to land punches in his fight.
And that's not taking nothing away from Nyambayar. It's just you don't play with your food, man.
Right. But Nyambayar pressured this fight. He pressured it. I ain't going to stunt. But why he let him off the ropes that time, I don't know what he was thinking.
Would I be mad if this goes to a draw or a split decision? I would not.
I will say this. It's not eventful for me to want to see it again, though.
No.
I would like to see Nyambayar fight somebody else. But, you know what I'm saying? I thought Nyambayar was going to bring the best out of Colbert. But he stuck with one punch majority of this fight. And that was the... overhand right. He wanted to land that a little too bad for me. Oh, okay, Toxic Piggy, what's happening? He said I'm not a troll.
Okay.
That's what's up. Sometimes we don't be knowing Toxic.
Some people just come in with some different type stuff and be on some other type stuff.
Yeah. Ain't no disrespect. No disrespect, Toxic Piggy. We just don't be knowing. But you jumped right out, though. Let's go.
Really,
I tell you what, hit that like button for me one time if you can. It's free. See, this is what I'm saying. You got this man, anybody got to chase this man down. I wouldn't be chasing nobody down. If you're not going to fight me, man, I'm be like, man, come on. I'm like, don't hug me. Round ended, he tried to like, thank you. No. Don't hug me. Chris Cyborg.
Oh,
He said he got a cold name, man. Toxic Peak. You know what I'm saying? We just seen some crazy names, bro. They are well thought, crazy ass names. Babu the Freak. I remember when I first started laughing, like, went like, what? And then the latest one was Bon Quickly.
I guess nobody else is covering this fight, huh?
I don't know. I think it was one other person that was that I saw on my timeline. There you go. If you're going to fight, now you want to fight the 12th round?
Yeah, some fast hands.
Yeah, Colbert do. He fast. It's just like, I don't know. They wasn't landing for him. See, he want that right hand bad. He want to land that right hand. He want to knock this little dude out so bad. But you ain't going to do it with the right hand. Prove me wrong if you can. Look at this, 109-100. Unofficial scorecard.
He can still... Nyambayar can still this round and actually win.
If he knock him down. He had to knock that dude out. Or knock him down. See what I'm saying? He just running, man. I don't... Bruh, somebody must told him that he was ahead for him to be doing that. I'd have been like, bro, no.
I would like to tell my fighter he's losing every round.
I wouldn't tell my fighter that because I could kind of mentally mess with him. But to give him the okay to do this, I don't like that. Nah, he not putting him down with that right. Nah, he not going to get it with that right hand. But Colbert could have put on a better performance. All in all, it still was a good fight. But I'm just saying that from watching past Colbert fights, you get what I'm saying?
Uh-huh.
From watching past Colbert fights, I know the capabilities of what he has. You know what I'm saying? I know what he's capable of. I be saying stuff hella backwards. But y'all know what I'm talking about. You know, he could look a lot cleaner than we've been doing. I don't know why he was somewhat one-dimensional this whole fight. Jab, jab, old right hand, jab, jab, right hook, jab, jab. You know what I'm saying?
It wasn't a full show of what he's capable of.
No. I've seen other fights where he showed what showed why he was mandatory. He showed why, you know what I'm saying? But I'm starting to think maybe it's what you say, you respect dude's hand speed or something a little too much. Like look at Nyambayar. Nyambayar trying to take his head off in these last seconds.
Fight over.
Zab's
a good guy, man.
Now, they lifting Nyambayar up, but I don't think he won. But nah, it wasn't impressive. It was a good fight. It just wasn't impressive. Colbert got other fights that's way more impressive than this. I don't know if he respected Nyambayar hand speed, you know what I'm saying, or whatnot. You know what I mean? But or they only trained to knock him out. You know what I'm saying? They thought they can get him out of there or something, but that right hand wasn't it. He landed the right hand like three times flush. That shit talking about that dude got a chin. I got to get him out of some other type of way. You know what I'm saying?
There was other ways. When somebody has a strong chin like that, just going around testing it isn't the thing to do. You have to catch that chin off guard.
Yeah, because dude was looking for it. That was the whole thing. He was looking for it the whole fight. The whole fight. Like I said, he threw so many overhands. Like I said, I think I only seen them landed maybe 3 or 4 times.
Mm-hmm.
But everybody, like I said, he'll bring it. You know, that's what he do right there, punches and bunches. You know what I'm saying? He try to mix it up. But seeing the strangers. See what I'm saying? See how Crisco was just swinging? You see how he just swinging? He's not even having a purpose in swinging.
He's just being active just for the hell of being active instead of. It didn't do nothing for me.
I'm watching that tomorrow, Chappelle. We were just talking about it earlier, though. I'm watching that tomorrow, the Four Kings. I am definitely watching that. I will be giving my say-so on it. I wish I could watch it with y'all, shit. But they don't let you, like, if I put it on the screen right now, it black, like, they smart now. They'll black, the screen just go black. Y'all will see black, but I wouldn't. You get what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. It's called the Kings.
The Four Kings. See, go lefty. He turned. Hey, guess what? One of the keys of victory is what you said. Basically turned to a lefty.
Uh-huh.
He didn't do that. Yep. One of old boy, keys of victory. It said, go lefty.
But he didn't do it.
Mm-mm.
Let's see.
Yeah, I'm most definitely watching it tomorrow.
What is it on? Showtime?
Showtime. You ain't got a pop fire stick?
No. That's fine.
Shit, you got a fire stick?
Nope. It's fine. I said it's fine. I have another way I can watch.
Oh, I was going to say, if you got a fire stick, it's so easy to pop it now. What'd you do to it? So, ma'am, to the TV? All right, go watch your tablet until I get ready to come down and I'll fix it, okay? Oh, it's working now. It's dead. It needs to be on charger. All right, what you keep scratching your face for? Come here. Look up. All right, there you go. I don't know what he's saying. But, yep, Colbert got it. We know it. What they saying? They'll do it again or something? Because I can't hear it because it'll try to come through. All right, G.
I got it. All right, y'all.
One.
Thank you.
Thank
you. Are they booing? Are they booing him?
Too much for him. He couldn't figure it out. Yeah.
He said he respected his power. He said he do hit hard.
What did you do to combat that constant pressure, particularly in those first 5 seconds. It's
crazy. Say what now? Hold on. Hold on. Man, I just was expecting seeing more, to be honest with y'all. I really was. All right. Hey, can you not pull on my chair? My baby is yanking on his chair. All right, did I do it right? There we go. There we go. There we go. Well animated. Boom. Yeah, he carried his power, whatever, but let me stop this. I don't even want to hear no more. They saying he dominated. He did dominate the fight in some instances, but to me, his arsenal for his Colbert, I'm talking about right here, Colbert, his arsenal should have been, he should have more variety going on for me. That's all it was. All of that jab, jab, overhand, jab, jab, right hook, jab, jab, like, what, he wasn't throwing nothing to the body. He wasn't setting nothing up real. Classic Nyambayar, he come to fight, is he throw punches and bunches. If I get you down, get you down. He could have set up something beautiful with a person like that and actually showcased his skills. That's what I want to see more of. 100%, you know, period. Stink, what are you doing? Oh, okay. So, I mean, I don't know. I just know it could have been a lot better. They only gave bro one round. Right, that's exactly. I wasn't even going to say nothing about that, but since you said something exactly, they got one round, early round at that, and I didn't see that. It was a couple more rounds than that, but you know what I mean? Especially the rounds at the end, of course you're going to give him the last two rounds. He ran the whole rounds. You couldn't touch him, you know, so.
You don't want to say excuse me.
Yes.
I am when I get done working. All right.
My baby want her TV. When we fix her TV so bad, she should be sleep sneaking up, being up.
You want to tell everybody hi? Hi, don't be shy now. You just talking. They heard you. Uh-huh.
Now she want to be shy. She ain't nowhere near shy. Anyway. Man, I'm going to let y'all go, man. Who won? Chris Colbert won. Lil B-Hop won, Chappelle. That's who I wanted to win, but not like that. I want him to showcase his skills a whole lot more than what he did. But nevertheless, he did get the win. I don't like the way they scored the fight. I feel like Nyambayar got more rounds than one round. It is what it is. But yeah, we got more fight commentaries coming up. Like I said, we will. The next media day coming up will be for Deontay Wilder versus Tyson Fury, which will be a dope one. So that starts on Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Them 3 days coming up, leading up to the 24th, I think they fight on. I believe so, of this month. So we're going to have the interviews, all that. Look forward to that stuff. Also, if you haven't caught my latest video upload I did, Anthony Joshua versus Alexander Usyk, trust me, you want to see that dope vid I did. Because people sleeping on that match coming up on September 25th. And if you listen to the video, you'll see what I'm talking about, all right? And I appreciate all the support from everybody. Everybody who came through, hit that like button. Everybody who actually shares the videos. Everybody who actually subscribe. You know what I'm saying? Hey, we working over this way, man. We trying to go up. You know what I'm talking about? Yeah, and everybody, man, happy 4th. Enjoy y'all weekend, man. I'll see y'all again tomorrow, all right? Y'all be easy. Deuces. Oh, don't forget about August. We're going to be out there in Vegas. If you live in Vegas, somewhere close to Vegas, come hang out with us, man. Trust me. We're trying to make sure something orchestrated on that Saturday. It's going to be lit. And don't forget, we're going to be live in studio for y'all to come mess with us, man. If you're in Vegas, mess with your boy. You know what I'm talking about. Me and Polo J going to be out there with Mr. Z. We're going to be doing it, man. We out here working for real, y'all. All right, having said that, I'm up out of here, man. E-Dub, Chappelle, my regulars, man, I really appreciate y'all. All my new cats, yeah, I appreciate y'all. We up out of here, all right? Deuces.